Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, world over. Green morning, good afternoon, and green evening to everybody in the different continents, in the different countries across the globe, wherever our brothers and sisters are. First of all, my sincere apologies that today we are starting the program 17 minutes late, because today in India, there is a celebration going on with regard to India Teachers Day. So there was a program from 9:30 onwards, and just now the program got over of Vivekananda Foundation, that was for all the way from Belur Math, which was being done, Swami Vivekananda's teachings and his inputs towards Indian education system, Indian youth, teachers, everybody. So my sincere apologies on that. Now let me just get across to the entire globe, and let me share, and while wishing the good morning to everybody in Canada, United States and Latin America, whether you're on the East Coast or you're on the West Coast, each one of us, wherever you are, it's a green morning. It's a wonderful morning. I hope you are taking care of your health, your wellness, and you're taking care of your friends, your family, your neighbors, your community, and everybody whosoever is around you. And from there, let me move to Europe. You all have taken your lunch, and post lunch, before you go for your evening tea and coffee, we are there with you for a short while, all of us together. So let's spend some time, and we extend a very hearty welcome to all our brothers and sisters. Those are joining us from Europe, that particular continent. From there, I bring you to Central Asia. People, those are joining us from Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, and of course, all the other parts nearby in Central Asia. A very hearty welcome to each one of you for a wonderful evening, Ayurveda for the Global Wellness. Let me also take you to Port Louis in the Mauritius, and let me also take you to Seychelles. All our brothers and sisters, those join us from there, extend you a very hearty welcome. When we talk about South Asia, people, those are joining us from Afghanistan, Bhutan, Sri Lanka, Nepal, Maldives. It's a great pleasure to have all of you for this particular program. And coming on Saturday evening, where we talk about your yoga, meditation, naturopathy, wellness, Ayurveda, nutrition, organic, and taking care of your health the best possible way. Let me take across to the Middle East. People, those join us from Saudi Arabia, those join us from Doha, Qatar, Oman, those come from Kuwait, and those join us from Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, Dubai. We extend you a very hearty welcome for joining us for yet another very powerful evening. We also take you to Asia, ASEAN region. And when I talk about the ASEAN region, 650 million population, people right from Myanmar, Cambodia, Laos, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, Brunei, and of course, Vietnam, all the 10 countries together, wonderful. And they have got a lot common to do with the northeast part of India, to which the Indian Prime Minister is called as a Asht Lakshmi. So ladies and gentlemen, this evening we have got very eminent panel. We have got our distinguished guests. Those are going to talk to us on how to say goodbye to the diabetes. And as there is a proper request, so today when we are coming to the 18th program, I requested Namo Gange, I requested Anshul Agrawalji. From here onward, the new journey will start as the request has been made, that instead of having different subjects, let's focus on one subject every Saturday, and we should get you all kind of an inputs, expertise, so that you get the best of treatment. At the same time, our distinguished panelists, these are the warriors, these are the people, those have been sent as a very special messenger by the God Almighty to take care of all of you on this planet Earth in different continents. So they would also be posting their details, their contacts, and their organizations in the chat box. And where from you can reach them directly. The basic aim is that through this particular platform, we should be in a position to, through the Namo Gange and the International Chamber for Service Industry, we should be in a position to help the humanity the best possible way. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking from 9:30 onwards in the morning. And when I started the day, and I think at the age of 70, if you can well imagine what must have been passing through and running through, 137 speakers since morning from the world have been handled. And this is the last program, the finale, where I got to take care of my health also and your health also together through Namo Gange and ICSI. So first of all, right from my country, we extend a very hearty welcome to everybody in India and Happy Teachers Day to everyone. Those are there on the soil and that beautiful country, and that is called India. On Saturday, 5th of September 2020, India's Teacher Day. All the teachers, you are doing a wonderful job. Our chamber since 1994, ladies and gentlemen, initially in India, there used to be a Punjabi Parvasi Divas from 1994 to 2003. And in 2003, then the Prime Minister of India, Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji, he took a decision when the presentation and deliberations and everything was done. He told with Punjabi Parvasi Divas, why not to start Bharatiya Parvasi Divas as well. And that was the journey from 2003. So he asked, your chamber does Punjabi Parvasi Divas when? We boldly, gracefully, enthusiastically said it's on 13th of January because that's a Punjabi's festival when we all are together and that's we celebrate Lohri. He said, wonderful. Keep doing it on 13th of January. And Bharatiya Parvasi Divas to be done on 9th of January. So we all look towards each other, what the Honorable Prime Minister of India is conveying, what does he want to convey? So he said, 9th of January, Mahatma Gandhi ji came back on the soil of India from South Africa. So who could be a better non-resident Indians than Mahatma Gandhi ji? And that was the birth of Bharatiya Parvasi Divas. So this wonderful journey, what we have got, 30 million non-resident Indians world over. Our chamber is a confluence of non-resident Indians, corporate, and the government interface when we talk about. So ladies and gentlemen, whether it's a market research or a policy advocacy, or it's the innovative strategies or consultancy or skills or training or competencies or policy papers, whatever you talk about, white paper, action plan, roadmap, and strategies, whatever is there. But we are very happy that lots of papers what we have made and given to Government of India from time to time. Namo Gange, we are grateful, we are thankful, and particularly the young, dynamic, vibrant Anshul Agarwal ji, because Namo Gange, health and wellness, nature and environment, kala and sanskriti, women empowerment, of course, wonderful they are doing. Every Saturday, they are the part of our journey. Heartiest congratulations to everybody in India. Today, India Teachers Day. And Government of India, Honorable Prime Minister of India, the Cabinet, and the HRD Ministry, renamed as Education Ministry now. So everybody in India, when we talk about congratulations, jubilations, celebrations, and whatsoever we can talk about, the new education policy announced on 29th of July, just about a month and few days back. So when we talk about this particular policy, the first one came in 1968, second in 1986, minor changes in 1992, and now this new education policy. Once it gets implemented, wonders would be done on this particular planet. With education, we also talk about your wellness, and I got to be talking about my wellness also, because since morning I'm sitting on this chair from 9:30, and you can well imagine at the age of 70, when talking as a 20-year-old boy, how much energy and synergy is required, because it's a very difficult task to do three webinars in one day from 9:30 to 9 p.m. But I'm dedicated, devoted to India. Whatever best we can do in India, we would love to do from here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, during lockdown, thought processes are affected, business is affected, physical and mental health is affected. Over here, the warriors are going to talk about. And the main part of the universe is education is deeply affected. But we say Vasudev Kutumbakam, one love, one world, one family. All of us, we are together wherever we are world over. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your pain is our pain. And that's the way we want to look at the entire thing. Monday to Sunday. Yes, you heard rightly. I am not talking about Monday to Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You should enjoy a holiday. Who told that Sunday is a holiday? Huh? Who told? There is no holiday on Sunday. Why? Absolutely. The people who came to India, who went to India, or who visited India, they wanted to enjoy. They wanted to have holidays. They built hill stations. They built a lot of summer vacations. And they were having a honeymoon and enjoyment over there in India. But Monday to Sunday, we got to work. Look at the India's Prime Minister. 6 years in the chair, in the office, not a single day he has taken the vacation. So many ideas, so many creativities. I think his entire team is so vibrant and dedicated, and that's what each one of in India has to do. And we from our chamber is trying to make education relevant. It's a global confluence of educators, motivators, and trainers, and psychologists, and counselors, and psychiatrists. We are also focusing on women empowerment in our education series, because that's very important. And the next crisis world over is going to be on water. Water shortage, water strategies to be taken care of. Jal hi jeevan hai. Jal sanrakshan is very important. Water conservation is very important. So it's a part of deliberation every evening by all of us, except on Saturday, because that's dedicated to Anshul Agarwalji for Ayurveda. Every Friday evening, 500 million people, and I do not know why people shy to come in the webinar, to log in over there, because people will come to know that you are becoming student, you're learning something, you're educating yourself. Don't feel shy. Don't think about it that what people think about you. Just bother about yourself. People feel like coming on Facebook. They want to come in watch party where nobody is seeing you. And you log in with a different name, with a different background and all together. Anyway, enjoy yourself, because the basic aim is to make you happy. As long as you are happy, we are happy. Come on the Facebook, Dr. Gulshan Sharma's page. Open your watch party. Let more and more people. And I always tell everybody, it's not good that now the things are getting patent abroad and they are repackaged and they are going back to India of the Ayurveda. That's not correct, because our old Vaidyas, they did not discuss their pathies with humanity. They took away with them to the graveyard only. They took away with them from this universe. Had they shared with others, today altogether the strategy and the groundwork would have been altogether different. So every Friday evening, I'm talking about Lord Buddha. Why I'm talking? Because Nalanda University. When you talk about Nalanda, why Nalanda? Because today, what we talk about Ayurveda, Charak Rishi, what you talk about, all the Ayurveda, ladies and gentlemen, it was a part of Nalanda, the first residential university. Somebody would say Takshila. Takshila was not residential university. It was a non-residential. It was Nalanda, which was the first residential university with 10,000 students, 2,000 acharyas, and you name whatever was required and desired over there. Every subject was being taken care of and all that. So thereby everybody got to realize, come Sunday morning, every Sunday morning, we take the journey, Vidya se Adhyatam Vidya ki or. What exactly is that journey? What is the relevance of Srimad Bhagavad Gita and India's top principal Upanishad in today's education system? What exactly, how the education system can be empowered world over? Nobody wants to go to hospital. Nobody wants to undergo surgery. They want to go to Ayurvedist. They want to take Ayurveda. They want to take wellness therapy, because everybody is thinking how to remain well without undergoing any surgery and getting the system opened up. Every Sunday evening at 5 p.m., we have got India ASEAN series, and there we talk about India and ASEAN together. Of course, the focus is northeast part of India, what Indian Prime Minister calls Ashta Lakshmi, those eight states, beautiful states, what we have got in India, right, starting from Tripura, coming to Manipur, coming to Assam, going to Meghalaya, going to Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, and Sikkim. All the states, when we talk about, ladies and gentlemen, these are eight beautiful states. So northeast part of India, along with the India and ASEAN, is the series every Sunday. So you can enjoy. Then a lot of businesses have been lost. A lot of people who started their own business, they are having challenges. So micro, small and medium enterprise. We are thankful to Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise. We have been walking in the corridors, submitting the papers, white papers, roadmap, action plans, strategies, what all is to be done for service industry, because our chamber is dedicated to service industry. So we are very happy that Finance Minister of India the other day, Madam, she announced over there, Nirmala Sitaramanji, that here onward, the manufacturing and the services will be taken at par in India. So under the dynamic and dedicated leadership of CMD of the NSIC, every evening, Sunday evening, 7 p.m., like you have got Saturday today, tomorrow evening, 7 p.m., you can witness this particular program. Now, the entire research which has been carried out world over by our chamber, and you see it over here, three things. Golden Triangle is no more Delhi, Agra, Jaipur. The B2B is no more business to business. It is back to basics. And what are the three Golden Triangle principles? Number one, take care of your basic food. Cultivate your own food. Main khud apni sabjiyan uga raha hoon. खुद अपना न्यूट्रिशन खाना खा रहा हूँ. घर की छत पे किसी भी घर के कोने में कोई भी जगह मिली है वहां पर मैंने सब्जी उगा दी है. न्यूट्रिशन एंड ऑर्गेनिक वो सारी सब्जी अगले एक महीने के लिए मुझे कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. सो लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेक केयर ऑफ योर बेसिक फूड. एंड इफ यू नो व्हाट यू आर ईटिंग, व्हाट इज गोइंग इनसाइड द बॉडी, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज देन यू कैन रिमेन हेल्दी. सेकेंड पार्ट ओवर हियर इज योर थॉट प्रोसेस, योर माइंड, योर बॉडी. हम जिम में जाते हैं. We devote more time on our body, beating the packs. And when I talk to Tim Grover, the coach of the Michael Jordan in America, whenever I visit him and I talk to him and discuss with him, he says, hey, you know, we devote more time on our body, not on our mind. If we devote little time on our mind. So ladies and gentlemen, that's why in the armed forces, Army, Navy, Air Force, paramedical and territorial army, wherever you are, they make you mentally strong. They make you mentally robust. And anybody who is mentally strong and mentally tough, no corona. Why corona? What corona? There's nothing of that sort. You can overcome any pandemic. So thereby, health, herbal, happiness, and holistic healing. And we are going to talk today, this evening, about your diabetics and diabetes, how to overcome different modes and different areas. Third part is education. The digital education, e-education, flip learning, digital learning, technology-based learning, education will not get back to the classroom now. All the teachers today, and that's what we have been telling you from morning 9:30 a.m. while you are celebrating India's Teacher Day in India, and understand India, the world has moved on. What was to come after 10 years, it has come as a tsunami with the technology, and entire education system is going to be now technology-based. So ladies and gentlemen, morning till evening, morning 9 o'clock till evening 9 o'clock, 12 hours complimentary. We are rendering the services to the whole world, right? Starting from Mongolia to the Mauritius, anywhere you talk about Latin America, where the Spanish is the main language, trying to reach out to all the countries. These were the legends since morning who were there to deliberate, discuss, empower the entire education system. We started in the morning and finished just before. And just before this program, Mataji was here and she was the one who talked about positive thinking, and that was Swami Vivekananda's teaching for education and youth empowerment. This program we just finished. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the entire week series. What we have got, our chamber has got one philosophy: whatsoever human mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. So let's come together, all the people world over, those are positive, thinking positive, talking positive, walking positive, sleeping positive, getting up positive. It's the global confluence of positive people. This is the song we have launched for India today. We have dedicated from our chamber and we have given it to India. That is Vishw Guru Banna Hai Bharat, Bharat Ka Samman Karo. And this song has been dedicated now on India's Teachers Day. Now let me come. These are the warriors and the yodha of today's evening. When I'm going to talk to all of you, ladies and gentlemen, let me extend a very warm welcome. Dr. Abhishek Kumar Srivastava ji, Nadi Parikshan and Panchkarma Specialist, Shri Shri Tattva Panchkarma Center. Oh, Shri Shri Ravi Shankar ji. Arvind ji has already come over here. Your university, which is at Cuttack, that lady Kulkarni ji, she had come over here. Your vice chancellor has come on this program, and the other day we had another director, and you have started one beautiful program also over there in that university. So hearty welcome to Dr. Abhishek Kumar Srivastava, an ever smiling gentle face. Yes, wonderful, a perfect example of living with Ayurveda. He practices what is preached. This is what his patients talk about him. He is dedicated to Ayurveda and how to heal people with Ayurveda have taken him to many countries abroad. He traveled extensively in India, conducting Nadi Pariksha camps, and was sent to Canada to promote Ayurveda. He was quite some time in Muscat, Oman, to Shri Shri Ayurveda Clinic. His expertise are lifestyle disorders, skin diseases, digestive issues, and arthritis. He traveled extensively in Gulf for consultation and awareness program. A hearty welcome to Dr. Abhishek Kumar Srivastavaji. People must be wondering what this man is doing and why is he doing this exercise and all. Education should not be theoretical, it should be practical. If I'm talking about wellness program and wellness therapy and anti-diabetes this evening, if I'm tired since morning, I've got to be putting my body with the positive energy in a positive frame. We have got another smiling face over here, Dr. Abhay Kulkarni ji. He seems to be from Maharashtra in India, founder and CEO, Yushri Ayurvedic Hospital and Research Center, Nasik. Yes, Nasik. Aapke paas to note chhapne ki machine hai wahan par Nasik mein, India mein. Great. He has a clinical experience of about 27 years. He has been appointed as a committee member for upgradation of Ayush Wellness Center of the prestigious Rashtrapati Bhavan of India. Dr. Kotecha ji, we send you greetings on today, India's Teachers Day, the Secretary of the Ministry of Ayush. Apart from being a clinician, he is a renowned research professional and is working on EMR extramural research projects on diabetes, neurotherapy, and COVID-19 allotted by Ministry of Ayush, Government of India. Dr. Katoch, I send you my greetings from overseas today to India in Ministry of Ayush along with Dr. Kotecha. Dr. Abhay has many papers and research articles to his credit published in peer-reviewed journals. Dr. Abhay is a member of Steering Committee for Research in MUSH, Maharashtra University of Health Sciences. Great. Dr. Abhay is a popular teacher and academician. He is visiting associate professor in an Ayurvedic college in Maharashtra. Dr. Abhay is a Senate member of the reputed Maharashtra University of Health Sciences in Nasik. He is an author of over 1,500 articles published in local newspapers, magazines, scientific journals, etc. He has written 3 books on Ayurveda for the public. One of its work is translated in Hindi, Gujarati, and English. Dr. Kulkarni ji, Marathi mein bhi humko leke aana chahiye tha. Dr. Abhay has published audio CDs of Garbha Sanskar in Marathi, Hindi, and English. Iske baare mein zarur batayega. I would like to learn what is Garbha Sanskar. So, iske baare mein bhi, okay, fine, we would understand. Here comes a smart Sikh gentleman and Dr. Gagandeep Singh, Ayurvedic consultant, Gopal Ayurvedic Specialty Clinic, Delhi. A pleasure to have you with us. Practicing Ayurveda for the last 15 years at Gopal Ayurvedic Specialty Clinic, Delhi. Hearty welcome to you. I recall and I remember when I was with the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, I used to go to Acharya Braspati Dev Trigunaji, that is at Sarai Kale Khan, when I prepared some videos for him with Maharishi from Noida. Okay. Clinic is going to complete 50 years serving and treating people through Ayurveda. Great. 50 years. So that's going to be golden jubilee. Okay. Specialized in chronic diseases and lifestyle disorders like liver diseases and diabetes. He has written 2 to 3 articles on liver, diabetes, and stress. Member National Ayurveda Student and Youth Association. Certificate in diabetes, that is Mellitus Royal Liverpool Academy, United Kingdom. So you are right over here in our city. Great. Now we have got Dr. Ramya Krishnan. Has to be from South. Okay. Associate Professor and HOD, Rajiv Gandhi Ayurveda Medical College, Puducherry. Oh, Puducherry. Kiran Bedi ji. Dr. Kiran Bedi ji is over there. And also Puducherry University is a Sikh gentleman who is a Vice Chancellor. Dr. Ramya Krishnan is Associate Professor in HOD, Department of Dravya Gun Vigyan.
Vigyan, sir.
Okay. Rajiv Gandhi Ayurveda Medical College, Government of Puducherry, Mahe. She did her BAMS from Vidya Ratnam Ayurveda College, Ullur, and MD from Government Ayurveda College, Trivandrum. It should be now known as Trivandrumpuram. She did her PhD from Rajasthan Ayurveda College, Jodhpur. She has 17 years clinical experience and 13 years teaching experience. She had delivered lectures in PMEs and presented papers in several national seminars. She has authored several articles on different topics in Ayurveda in leading national dailies and also in international e-journals. She appeared as a guest in several television channels in Ayurveda awareness programs. Her previous publications are Evidence-Based Ayurveda and Rational Prescribing, first edition 2012, second edition 2017, and Ayurveda Gynecology, revised and updated first edition 2016. Dr. Ramakrishnan, along with Dr. Rajkumar, are proponents of a novel, streamlined, scientifically updated version of Ayurveda, technically termed as science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda community called SBEBA, Sabeba, Wisdom Series all over India, with the objective of transforming Vaidyas from medicine prescribers status to Bishop. Okay, scientific practitioner, with the slogan Bharat Mission Bishop. Great, thank you very much. Because you studied in Trivandrumpuram, so I give you a little run. During the Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, I drafted the whole plan and the master plan for medical tourism when I traveled from Ponmudi to Trivandrumpuram, Trivandrumpuram to Varkala, Varkala to Alappi, Alappi to Koyalon, Koyalon to Vaipin, Vaipin to Ernakulam, Ernakulam to Trichur, Trichur to Kottayam, Kottayam to Thekkady, Thekkady to Idukki, Idukki to Periyar, Periyar to Sabarimalai, and then I moved on to Tamil Nadu to Madurai, that is Meenakshi temples, where we had gone. And ladies and gentlemen, here we have got Dr. Pundarikaksha Rauji. Heartiest welcome. He is Associate Professor and HOD, Ayurveda College, Coimbatore. Oh, Coimbatore. Our Chicago, Sadhguruji. Wow, Coimbatore. Yes, Lord Shiva's function, we attended over there. Dr. Rao, he is a MD, BAMS, MS Sanskrit, working as Associate Professor and HOD in the Department of Shala Kyantra of Ayurveda College, Coimbatore. He has completed post-graduation from Dr. BRKR Ayurveda College and Research Center, Hyderabad in 2011, and undergraduate medical degree from SV Ayurvedic College and Hospital, Tirupati, Ayurveda, Andhra Pradesh in 2007. He has 8 years of teaching experience in the capacity of a lecturer and also associate professor. He had been teaching the subject of Ayurvedic ophthalmology and ENT to undergraduate Ayurvedic students and has been an examiner for these examinations in different institutions under the Tamil Nadu Dr. MGR Medical University, Chennai. During his distinguished career, 53 scientific papers were published in international and national journals and delivered 25 guest lectures and paper presentations in national and international seminars. 195 patients of eye and ENT were operated surgically by Ayurvedic method, and more than 7,000 patients were treated so far by non-surgical methods. So I think, ladies and gentlemen, this was the last program. So with these words, I extend a very hearty welcome. And I tell Anshul Agarwal ji, he got to moderate today's deliberation and discussions. You kindly take on today. Okay. So fine. Let Dr. Srivastava start. And thereafter, I was thinking you will have a mercy on the old man and you will try and give me some energy and synergy as a younger brother from India, because you can well imagine that since morning Anyway, I will take on, no problem. Abhishek ji, let's start with you. Abhishek Kumar Srivastava ji, let's start the evening with you. But Anshul ji, you've got to give me the sequence. You got to just tell me so that at least I'm not a defaulter anywhere. Please give me the sequence.
Sir, in that scenario, we'll go as per the creative we have made.
Sir, I have not seen the creative here in Singapore. So be kind enough that you just give me the names. Dr. Abhishek, I've got now. So that I got by my choice. Now next you give me.
Okay. Sir, we start with Dr. Abhishek Kumar Srivastava ji. And he will go to speak about causes for the diabetes. Then we'll go to Dr. Abhay Kulkarni ji. He will talk about the line of treatment for diabetes. Then we'll go to Dr. Gagandeep Singh ji. And Gagandeep ji will talk about the few food and lifestyle changes required for the diabetes.
Okay.
Then Dr. Ramya Krishnan ji with reference to the curative strategies for the masses. And then in the end, we have Dr. Rao. And he will going to talk about diabetic retinopathy and its management.
Okay, wonderful. Now, all the five warriors, संसार पांच तत्वों से बना है, हाथों में पांच उंगलियां हैं, आप पांच योद्धा हैं, आप पांच वॉरियर हैं, आप पांच आज के सेलिब्रिटीज हैं, आप मेरे लिए अक्षय कुमार से कम नहीं हैं इंडिया में, with due respect, because you are the people, those are going to empower the humanity, you are the people, those are going to empower the entire universe, so thereby जब ये प्रोग्राम खत्म हो जिनको वर्ल्ड ओवर डायबिटीज है उन सबकी डायबिटीज खत्म हो जानी चाहिए दैट इज द वे वी शुड गिव द एंटायर पैकेज एंड वी शुड वर्क आउट दैट वे सो विद दैट एंथुसियाज्म व्हेन अंशुल इज नॉट रेडी टू शेयर द रिस्पांसिबिलिटी आई विल टेक ऑन द कंप्लीट रिस्पांसिबिलिटी एंड श्रीवास्तव जी लेट्स स्टार्ट विद यू इन अ वंडरफुल वे एंड देयर आफ्टर आई विल इनवाइट माय ब्रदर्स एंड माय सिस्टर ऑल ऑफ यू टुगेदर एंड वी विल वर्क आउट And I send you all my greetings to everybody in India. And let's start with Dr. Abhishek Kumar Srivastava ji. Ab time aapka hai, duniya aapki hai, sansar aapka hai. Main aapko nahi rokunga, kahi beech mein nahi tokunga. Lekin ye bata dunga Anshul ji ko mobile pe ki log aapki talk ko enjoy kar rahe hain ki nahi kar rahe hain. Because the talk has to come from heart. It is something like why you enjoy a particular teacher's class and why you don't enjoy a particular teacher's class in the same school and same institution. When it will come from the heart, people are going to enjoy. So let's share your vision, your expertise, and let's make the whole universe today diabetic free. With these words, let's start with Dr. Abhishek Kumarji.
Very good evening to Dr. Gulshan Sharma ji. And to all the panelists who are accompanying me and to all the friends who are watching me throughout the world. So today we will learn about diabetes. So I will share a small presentation.
Isko full size kar lijiye.
Yes. So first thing is, as today we are talking about Ayurveda, so let me start with the basics. What is Ayurveda? Ayurveda, because most of the time we take Ayurveda, as a mode of medicine. But Ayurveda is a term which is made up of two terms, Ayu and Veda. Means knowledge of life. How from the time of birth till we die, what all we should do so that we remain healthy. That includes diet, that includes lifestyle, that includes herbs, that includes panchakarma treatments. So basically, now first we will talk, before talking about diabetes, we will talk about what are the basic concepts of Ayurveda and how diabetes happens. So Ayurveda says that our body and in the entire world is made up of five basic elements: earth, water, fire, air, and space. These are the five elements of which the entire world is made up of. And as per Ayurveda, of these five elements, basically three doshas are made up of: vata, which is made up of air and space element, Pitta, which is made up of fire and water element, and Kapha, which is made up of water and earth element. Now, why they are called as doshas? You know, these dosha in Ayurveda, it is being told, dushyanti iti dosha, means which has a tendency of vitiation. Like, for example, suppose if you don't sleep properly at night, next day, the entire day, you feel uncomfortable, you feel some body pains, sometimes headache. So what has happened? Nothing has come from outside, but basically your vata has got aggravated. The air element in your body has got aggravated because you have not slept properly at night. In the same manner, when you keep fasting, when you do fasting or you don't eat properly, you know, some after that, what happens? You feel headache, you feel acidity, you feel sometimes migraine pains, sometimes sore throat, sometimes pain in the abdomen. So nothing has come from outside. Because you have skipped your meals or you have not eaten properly food, your pitta, the fire element, has gone aggravated. In the same manner, when you eat too much, like if you eat a heavy meal, like if you eat too much of milk products or sweets, today we will be talking about a lot about food. So if you take a very heavy meal or take a lot of milk products, a lot of sweets, so basically what happens in your body, water and earth element, because all these food items are heavy, so in your body also the water and earth element increases, which leads to increase of kapha. So basically it is our job to keep these doshas into balance. If we don't follow the rules of life, which has been told in Ayurveda, in Dinacharya and Ritucharya, then what is going to happen? Basically, these three doshas or any one of them or all three doshas get imbalanced. So basically, when we have to talk about that, what are the causes of diabetes? So what happens in diabetes, these all three doshas get imbalanced, and then they lead to the vitiation of our body tissues, even our malas also, and that leads to diabetes. Now, what are the causes which has been told in Ayurveda? Many people think that diabetes is a disease of modern world, but I wanted to tell you over here that in all our scriptures, whether you talk about Charak Samhita, Shushruta Samhita, Ashtang Hirde, in all the scriptures, diabetes has been written. A lot of details of diabetes has been mentioned, that how it happens, what should be the diet, what lifestyle changes you need. So in Charak Samhita, Chikitsa Sthan, this shloka is written and under the chapter Prameha. In Ayurveda, diabetes has been mentioned under chapter Prameha, and 20 types of Prameha has been mentioned. Why it has been mentioned in Prameha? Because Prameha means in which you get urination again and again. So that is one of the symptoms of diabetes, that is frequency of urination. So basically, what are the causes which has been mentioned for Prameha is Asya Sukham, Swapna Sukham, Dadhini, Gram Udak, Anu Prasapayansi, Navannapanam, Gud Vakratam, Pramehetu Kafkrit Sarvam. So as I told you, that in diabetes, all the three doshas get imbalanced, but the most prominent dosha is Kapha dosha. And the main dosha for Prameha, which has been mentioned in Ayurveda, is Kapha dosha. So it has been told, Asya Sukham means if you are sitting, if you are not doing much of physical activity, you are living a very luxurious life and you're not doing much of walking any, and your entire day you're sitting, not doing much of exercise and not doing any walking, you know, no physical activity at all. So that is called as Asya Sukham. Swapna Sukham, if you are sleeping too much, even the day in today's world, a lot of people don't sleep. They go to bed very late and they are sleeping in the morning till late hours. So, Swapna Sukham, either you are sleeping too much for the entirety, or if you are sleeping more in the morning hours. Because in Ayurveda, it has also been told that the entire day has been divided into Kapha Kal, Pittaj Kal, and Vataj Kal. So morning 6 to 10 is the Kaphaj Kal. The more you sleep in the morning hours, the more Kapha you accumulate. So Asya Sukham, Sapna Sukham, Dadhini. Dadhini means yogurt and other milk products which has a lot of fat. So Dadhini and other milk products. Gram Udak Anu Prasa Payansi means meat of domestic and aquatic animals. Domestic animals like cow, buffalo, sheep, which has a lot of fat. So meat of domestic and aquatic, or aquatic like crab, animals like crabs, tortoise. So if you are eating meat of these animals, then Nava Annapanam. Nava Annapanam means Naya Ann, with freshly harvested greens. Why it has been told? In Ayurveda, it has been told the freshly harvested greens are heavy to digest. They are heavy to digest. When a green is harvested, at that time it has more kapha. So it requires, in our body, it takes more time to digest. So all the greens which are freshly harvested, Nav Annapanam, Gud Vakratam means any type of sugar and its derivatives. That includes jaggery also, because many people think that if they are eating jaggery, jaggery is fine. But jaggery and other sweet products, definitely jaggery is less harmful than white sugar. But that is also, if you are eating too much, then that is also going to harm you. And Prameh Hetu Kafkrit Sarvam means anything which increases your kapha. All are the causes of diabetes. Anything which increases your kapha. So these are the asisukham, sapnasukham. If you're not doing of much of physical activity, sapnasukham means if you are sleeping for long hours in the morning, or in, if you are resting too much, you're not doing much of physical activity. Then milk and milk products, food which has a lot of fat, that includes non-vegetarian items also. Then Navannapanam, the new greens, then sugar and its products, and any food item which increases kapha, that we are going to discuss in detail. So here is the summary, basically what has been told over here. Lethargic and physical inactivity. So what happens if we don't do much of exercise? When we are not doing much of exercise, what happens is, basically our agni goes low, our digestive fire goes low. So what happens is more of ama formation in the body, means toxin formation in the body. So because of that, diabetes happens. Then again, I told you that sleeping for long duration or during morning hours, or even less sleeping also, it has also been found that if you are, because in today's modern world, lack of sleep is also very common. People are sleeping like only for 4 hours or 5 hours. So sleep is the time when your body regenerates. And if you are having a good sleep, it reduces the insulin resistance in your body. So sleeping at the right time, in the right duration, that is very, very important. If you are sleeping at for less hours, or sleeping basically at the wrong time, then basically it can cause more and more insulin resistance is going to happen, and it can lead to diabetes. Then curd and milk products. Curd and milk products, why in previously it is written in Ayurveda, but now even many modern doctors are also accepting that basically the milk and milk products has like insulin-like proteins, you know, which what happens because of that, insulin helps our body sugar to go inside the cells. But it is like a duplicate key. It is like a duplicate key which does not enter the sugar inside the cells. And because of that, more insulin resistance happens and we are not able to metabolize the milk products. And meat dishes with high fat. I have seen in many patients, those who take, it is not only about meat dishes, basically, if you are eating a lot of fried food or junk food, then our liver functions get disturbed. And because of improper liver functions, what happens, our sugar does not metabolize. And one more thing I want to tell you that if you are not, our sugar gets metabolized in our liver, it gets metabolized in our muscles. So if you are not doing much of physical activity, even the sugar at the peripheral level, that also does not get absorbed. And because of that, you know, our sugar levels increases. So when we have more, like many patients who have fatty liver, I've seen patients who have fatty liver, they also after some time, they develop high blood sugar levels because they are not able to metabolize sugar. So if till now we have read that basically because of eating sugar, we get diabetes. But if you are eating more of fatty diet, if you're not, because many patients come to us, they tell us that we are not eating sugar at all, then 2 hours sugar is not going down. Because they don't know that they are not eating sugar, but on the other hand, they are eating a lot of fried items, a lot of milk products like cheese, butter, all these items which is causing more fatty liver and which is causing more insulin resistance. And because of that, their sugar levels are increasing. Then freshly harvested grains. As I told that, if we keep the grains, when I was like a child, at that time in India, there was a tradition that grains were first cleaned and then they used to be kept for about 6 months to 1 year. And after that, you know, they were grinded and then chapati and all were made from that. So basically, and now what is happening is in today's world, what is happening is we are taking the wheat flour from the malls, basically. So we don't know that how old the grains are. And because we are taking, most of the time, we are taking the freshly harvested, whether it is rice or whether it is wheat, what is happening is it is heavy to digest. And because of heavy digestion, it is all causing more ama. And because of more ama, it is leading to high sugar levels. Then definitely sugar products. Sugar products, if you are eating too much of sweets, then what is happening? That much our sugar is not being metabolized by the insulin and it is leading to high sugar levels. Then fatty food. Fatty food, basically, as I mentioned that, then our liver functions get affected because of more fat and more calories, and that leads to insulin resistance. And because of that, our sugar is not being metabolized. The same thing happens with alcohol, because many patients ask this during our practice that can we take one peg of alcohol in a day? See, as I said that liver is a very, very important organ to metabolize sugar. So if any of the thing, whether it is any infection or more fatty food or lack of exercise or more alcohol, which is causing deterioration or degeneration in the activity of liver. And because of that, you know, more insulin resistance, and because of that, our sugar is not being able to metabolize. Then sweet, sour and salty food. As it is written in the shloka, that anything which increases kapha is going to increase your sugar levels. So most of the time we listen that sweet causes more diabetes. But in Ayurveda, there are 6 tastes, sweet, sour, salty, bitter, pungent, and astringent. So basically, sweet, sour, salty is the taste which increases kapha. And but bitter, pungent, and astringent, that is katu, thick, and kasai is the rasa which causes basically reduction of kapha. So that is why if we are eating more of sweet, sour and salty food, then it can lead to basically more of kapha, and it can lead to more of sugar levels. Then in proper sleep, as I said, that sleep is a time when our body regenerates. If we are taking less sleep or very late we are going to bed or getting very late in the morning, if we are going to bed very late, then Vata imbalance is going to happen. Vata and Pitta imbalance is going to happen. And if we are getting very late in the morning, that most of the youngsters throughout the world are doing, they are getting up around 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. So what happens because of that? More kapha accumulation in the body, because 6 to 10 is kapha kal. So if we are in bed for longer duration in the morning hours, then more kapha accumulation, more heaviness, more indigestion in the body, and which can even lead to basically diabetes. Then sleep is also of two types, that is rapid eye movement and non-rapid eye movement. If we are not getting a good sleep, that is quality of sleep is not good, that is the REM sleep, rapid eye movement. If our mind is not relaxed, not peaceful, if it's too stressed, then our eyelids keep on blinking. That is called as a rapid eye movement. So the more relaxed our sleep is, the more calm we are, the less stressed we are, the better will be our sleep, the more regeneration it is going to happen, the lesser will be insulin resistance, and basically we will be able to metabolize the sugar levels. Modern science accepts the causes of diabetes as genetic susceptibility, obesity, physical inactivity, stress, and wrong diet. So as you have seen in the shloka, basically most of these things are there, because of lack of exercise and more fatty food, definitely obesity is going to happen. And because of stress, as I told you, insulin resistance is more. So basically, in modern, we see there are three types of diabetes. That is, first is type 1 diabetes, and second is type 2 diabetes, and third is gestational diabetes. So the most prominent one is type 2 diabetes. So the reason for type 1 diabetes, in Ayurveda, it has been told as Bij Dosh, means it is because of inheritance. Because of inheritance, this can happen, or it has also been told that it can be like autoimmune disorder. Because of autoimmune disorder, our beta cells don't function properly, and because of that, insulin formation is less, and that leads to type 1 diabetes. Then the type 2 diabetes, basically, main cause is insulin resistance. So as I mentioned in the shloka, and the modern doctors also accept that high fatty diet, which has been mentioned in the Ayurveda shloka, and fake carbohydrates, which is present in most of the cold drinks and bakery items, the sugar which is there in the all the cold drinks and artificial juices, and these bakery items like cakes, pastries. So basically all these have fake carbohydrates, and then which is one of the cause of insulin resistance. And lack of exercise, as I mentioned, that which leads to Agni Mant. And then the other thing which happens because of lack of exercise is improper lymphatic drainage. Like as sir said, that when we are sitting for as he was doing exercise while sitting also, so that what happens is when we are using our muscles, then the lymphatic drainage happens properly. And in many diabetic patients, we see that a lot of swelling starts happening in our body because of lack of exercise. That is because the lymphatic drainage is not happening properly. And lymphatic drainage happens when the muscle contraction happens. And muscle contraction happens only when you are doing some exercise or yoga postures like that. So for diabetes, along with walking, it is very important to do something which causes more and more muscle contraction, so that our lymphatic drainage improves. And as we do exercise, our digestive fire improves, the digestion of food improves, less toxin formation, and then we are safe from diabetes. Then stress, as I said, that stress leads to insulin resistance, which causes diabetes. Then acid and inflammation. In today's world, a lot of people are suffering from acidity and some or the other pain problems, you know, because of that, they keep on gulping antacids, they keep on gulping painkillers, and because of that it can lead to basically insulin resistance, and which can lead to diabetes in future. Then the sixth cause is lack of micronutrients. When we see patients, a lot of people are suffering from deficiencies like vitamins deficiency, vitamin B12, D3. So because of deficiencies of vitamins, insulin resistance is more, which is a very, very common cause, and we don't know that because of deficiency we are getting diabetes. We start the diabetic treatment, but we don't take the micronutrients, which is present in so many herbs, Ayurvedic herbs. Then insulin-like growth factors, which I have mentioned, that most of the milk products and its derivatives has insulin-like growth factors, which has been told in the shloka in Ayurveda 1000 before Christ, like Charak Samhita, the Kal of Charak Samhita, Shrutra Samhita. At that time, it was mentioned that milk and milk products are not good for diabetes, and now the modern doctors are accepting in today's world that because of these milk products has insulin-like growth factors, the insulin resistance is more, and because of insulin resistance, it leads to diabetes. So basically, these are the main reasons and main causes of diabetes. So thank you so much for your time, and I love to discuss the causes of diabetes over here. I have clubbed the modern and Ayurveda science together so that it can reach to each and every person of this world. Thank you so much.
Wonderful, Dr. Srivastavaji. It was wonderful, right from the heart. Wonderful presentation. Everybody watched it carefully. There are 2-3 questions I'll take on at the end. Let you close your presentation so that I can go to my second speaker. May I now extend a very warm welcome to Dr. Abhay Kulkarni. So Dr. Abhay Kulkarni ji, let's share your thought process. Unmute kiji apna mic.
And, yes, sir.
Please go ahead. We extend you a very warm welcome. Hearty welcome.
Thank you very much, sir. Very good evening to all of you, all of the eminent panelists and all the participants all over the globe. At the outset, I thank the organizers for inviting me as a panelist in this very important session. And I salute Dr. Gulshan Kumar ji for showing such an energy and such a enthusiasm and interest in from morning to evening. We envy you, sir. Thank you very much. I also thank Dr. Abhishek Kumar ji for an excellent introduction to diabetes and Madhumeha. It made my job really very easy. And now I'm going to come straight to the point, and I would like to talk about the line of treatment for diabetes in Ayurveda. This is a very important aspect that everybody needs to be educated about. And I would like to take you through the classical treatment program that is described in Samhitas. At the outset, I wish you all a very happy Teacher's Day. I would like to quote from Charaka Samhita. It says that Krishno hi loko buddhimatam acharyaha, shatruscha abuddhimatam. To the wise, the whole world is like a teacher, and to the unwise, the whole world is an enemy. I want to be a wise person, so I consider all of you as my teachers, and I salute you before we go on to the journey. Talking of friends and foe, I would like to introduce this disease as a friend and a foe at the same time. Diabetes is a friend if kept under control. If we control diabetes, then the disease, it's like a boon. It will help you to improve your quality of your health. It will improve the overall health, But if it is ignored and if it is left under uncontrolled, then there is no disease like diabetes. No, there is no enemy which can cause so much damage to you like diabetes. So it's a friend and foe to at the same time. Let us learn to friend this diabetes for the benefit of our health and for that of the whole world, because it is the biggest disease which can cause damage to the whole body, and the people don't know about when their body is damaged. So it's a very important disease and it needs to be treated carefully. So when we talk of treatment, let us talk about what are we going to treat? What do we want to treat? When we talk of treatment, all over the world, the whole focus is on blood sugar. Blood sugar is only a finding, and the whole treatment approach is concentrated on the sugar. And even the patient's questions also are concentrated around sugar. Like we have had a question in the chat that please talk about the fake carbohydrates. Definitely we are going to deal about it. So what I mean to say is all of them are concentrated only on whether these foods will increase my sugar or not, whether these medicines will decrease my sugar or not, how is my disease. So everything is about blood sugar. Let me tell you, friends, that Ayurveda is a holistic has a holistic approach to it. And yes, it tackles the issue of blood sugar, but it is not the only. Many people, diabetes, they treat as a disease as a whole, or sometimes they treat the body. But what we have to do in Ayurveda, we have an approach of tackling the whole body, because basically we treat the body according to Ayurveda and the disease in the body and then the findings of that disease. So this is the approach that Ayurveda has got. So let us talk about who comes to Ayurveda for treatments. So the most number, as I always tell to my patients and my students, that who detects the diabetes in a majority way, it is the insurance companies who detect the diabetes, because patients do not have any symptoms and signs. But when they go to take a policy, then they are diagnosed as diabetics. They are uncontrolled. They have no symptoms and they also don't know. So people come to us with high sugar levels without any symptoms. Then there are the patients who are diagnosed as pre-diabetics and they don't want to take metformin, and they want to take a natural approach to the treatment. And these people are the ones, this is a group of patients who come to Ayurveda for treatment. Now, non-diabetics taking medicines. Why these people come to us? Because they are fed up of the medicines and they want a natural approach and they want to get rid of the medicines. These are the people they come to Ayurveda. Then diabetes, what some disease, they have got the glimpse of some complications. So they don't want to, they want to avoid the complications. These people are the one who come to Ayurveda, and people with complications also come to us because they have nowhere to go. People like, since I am dealing with complications of diabetes, more like nephropathy and retinopathy and this cardiac diseases. So I get to see a lot of patients with complications. And let me tell you, Ayurveda, instead of focusing on blood sugar, we focus on preventing and managing the complications in a better way. And they increase the quality of life of diabetic patients in a great way. The Ayurvedic treatment is very useful for us. The last group of people, and very scarcely, these people come for prevention of diabetes. This is a very smaller group. As a physician, I would like more and more people to come for prevention, because that is the really strong area of Ayurveda, and we can help people in a great way in this to prevent, and that will be a service to the nation, to the families, and to the whole world, because this is an important aspect. Now, what do people just? I have since in 27 years of my practice, I have been getting the feedback of what people want from Ayurveda. The first thing that they want is the freedom from worry. They don't want to die a miserable death. This is the biggest worry. This is a result of survey of around 5,000 patients, which took the survey. And from that, these are the findings that had been collated. they want the freedom to from worry, because they don't want to die miserable, they don't want to want complications, they don't want to get hospitalized. This is the basic, the second number priority is to have an effective sugar control. If they are on insulin, they their sugar plays like an hide and seek, and sometimes it is low, sometimes it is very high. That is the problem. They don't have a solution. They only have to adjust the levels of insulin. So in such cases, what they want is a balanced kind of effective sugar control where they can relax. Weight loss is another area where which doesn't have an alternative in conventional medicine, and they try all sorts of things and they are not able to do that. Diet and exercise advice is an area of Ayurveda, because that is a patient-friendly, a user-friendly way of doing. People don't understand carbohydrates, minerals and vitamins and calories and everything. What they understand is the taste. They understand sweet, they understand bitter, they understand astringent. And Ayurveda is very user-friendly. It is easily, the principles are easily, they can be friend with the user and they can easily understand. So diet and exercise is an area where Ayurveda can help these people, and people come to seek this for them. Then psychotherapy, then counseling, is an area where people want from Vaidya. Conventional medicine doctors hardly talk any words. And then a lot of questions are left unanswered. And when they come to a Vaidya like us, then what they want is to hear them out and answer their questions, clear their doubts, and give an answer which is suitable, a tailor-made approach they need for diabetes. And this is what Ayurveda is does. Charaka says that like one who doesn't enter the heart of the patient, that is not a physician. So this is a very important aspect. Then a group of patients want complete eradication of diabetes. They want their diabetes to be completely gone. They want to be free from diabetes. They want to lead a normal life, eat, sleep, have sex, good quality life, better quality life. The another thing is that management of other comorbidities or other conditions like infertility, thyroid, osteoarthritis, prevention of complication and management of complications is what they look for. They come to an Ayurvedic physician with diabetes. So is Ayurveda able to cater to their needs? Yes, friends, Ayurveda has the ability to cater to all their queries, and very nicely they can lead a very good life with diabetes with Ayurveda. So what is the present scenario of treatment that is available in the market? People have this jambul bija or karela or neem or methi, all bitter and astringent substances. They think that it is an important treatment for diabetes. But let me tell you from the experience of my practice that this serves only certain part of the disease. So it is not able to give good sugar control, or it is not able to fulfill all the expectations that are required from the patients. So this is not an effective remedy. Then many physicians or many companies have in their products plants like gudmar. Like they think that when we eat this plant, we don't feel the taste of the substances, the sweetness of the substances. So people think that it is okay to eat sweets, but it is a deceptive drug. It works on the nervous system and not on the internal pathology of the disease. So this is also not very effective. Then certain classical formations like Madhumeha, Darpahari, etc., they have a different area of treatment. So they are also not completely fully useful for the treatment. Then some people use the formulations from Samhitas, classical texts. Yes, these formulations can give a fair control of diabetes, and it can be a good area of treatment. But diabetes is a lifestyle disease. It cannot be restricted only to medicines. We need to have advice about diet. We need to have an advice about exercise. We need to have an advice about overall behavior, planning of your daily activities, how do you conduct your work and everything. All these things are very important. Then some physicians say that just take a secondary approach. They assume a supplementary role. They treat only the symptoms and don't touch the disease. They leave it for other physicians. So all of these things are also not effective. So as a result, what happens is like five blind people describing an elephant. Then it is missing the whole picture. So people are confused whether we should treat prameha, meha, or madhumeha. These are the three names which in the scientific community there is a lot of discussion and debate about the names which is to be given, or whether to treat diabetes, or whether to treat blood sugar, or general debility, or complications, or fungal infections, low libido. What should be? So we are missing the whole picture. So Ayurvedic classical texts and the science of Ayurveda actually focus on treating the whole picture, because this is a very big disease. It is a big disease which cannot be controlled by single treatment modality. We need to have all modalities in place at the same time, and we need to watch. It's like an enemy. It can enter from any opening and any single space it can come. So we have to be very watchful about this disease. So this is the treatment approach. So what is the basic issue for treatment? The basic and first prime and foremost area remains the blood glucose levels. And our treatment needs to be addressed to reduce the blood glucose levels. The other part is, so people are dependent on the medicines to a large extent, and they want to continue their lifestyle as it is. So as a result, their body cells are not able to utilize the glucose for their needs. So we need to train your body to utilize the glucose. Thereby you can reduce the amount of medicines that you need, reduce the amount of molecules that you need, because people are taking one molecule of oral hypoglycemic drugs, two molecules, three molecules, a combination of three or four molecules. In addition to that, people are taking insulin. So if you train your body in such a way, if you plan your activities in such a way, then your body cells are able to utilize the glucose which is there in the excess. And even if the insulin is not working properly, you are still able to reduce the blood glucose due to your activities. That is the magic of physical activities. So we need to educate patients in managing the lifestyle in such a way that it is useful for them to control the blood glucose. Now, what are the treatment modalities that are used? As Dr. Srivastav has very nicely explained, the first line of treatment, which Ayurveda says that Sankshepataha Kriya Yoga Nidana Parivarjana. You need to first and foremost thing, you have to avoid the causative factors. It's like a tap is leaking from up on the upper position, and you keep on clearing the floor with the wiping the floor. That is not going to work. So you need to close the tap first. So that after that only you can mop the floor and you can make it dry. So this is the role of all causative factors in all diseases, but basically in diabetes, because the causative factors are very important, and the Samhitas and the classical texts also have emphasized a lot on causative factors. So diet, activities, and psychological approach are very important. Then the next line of treatment is detoxification. This is detoxification by way of Panchakarma. We need to, because the amount of etiology that has been generated, the amount of clay, the fluids that have been in excess in the body, they are so much that you cannot remove it with medicine. So those who are are indicated in Panchakarma, those patients who are indicated, they have strength, they are able to bear the treatment of Panchakarma, they should opt for Panchakarma, in which Vamana, the emetic therapy, a scientific process of throwing out the excess kapha from the body, is a very important thing. But you have to be very careful, and this has to be done under the supervision of a properly trained vaidya. Then only an experienced vaidya who can handle these patients. So this is a very important approach. So Panchakarma, Vaman is a very useful thing, and Virecham is the another therapy which is indicated. These are the two main Panchakarma procedures. These are used for as detoxification procedures in diabetes. and then the palliative medicines, which control, which we call as Samana therapy in Ayurveda. This is a disease. Diabetes is a disease in which we need a rejuvenative therapy. Rasayana chikitsa is, you have to combine rasayana chikitsa as a daily part in the patient's treatment, which is very important. Of course, diet, we have emphasized exercises and different physical activities. This actually do the magic. A lot of pre-diabetes patients can be only controlled on diet and exercise, and they cannot be done. And if they are advised proper panchakarma procedure, they are able to stop the progression of pre-diabetes to diabetes, and they can reverse the condition and lead a normal, healthy life. So this is the magic. And the physical activities, I also always advise my patients to keep on moving. Like whatever job they have, I advise them to every 15 minutes, they have to take a walk of 5 minutes, whether it is in the room itself or whether it is in the house also, that doesn't matter. But they must keep moving. They must do physical activities as much as possible. They can avoid taking the elevators. They should always make it a point to climb the stairs. They should make it a point to walk as much as possible. Then the psychological aspects are very important part. Because diabetes is a disease of kapha, there is a tendency of like falling prey to the diet. You must have seen chronic people or patients of diabetes. The more you tell them, you must not eat sweet, you must not drink alcohol, you must not do this, you must not do that, they will be very inclined to actually do the contrary. They will definitely make it a point whether they are liking sweets or not. But since they have become diabetes, they will always find a liking, develop a liking for sweets. And they will, like they are like a naughty child, they will break the rules the physician sets for them very often. And this is due to the moha, like tamoguna is there because it is of prithvi and apa. Since Dr. Srivastava has given the basics, trained us for the basics also, let me tell you that this is a disease of prithvi and kapha. And because it is a disease of prithvi and kapha, there is a tendency, it is tamoguna bahula prithvi. So the tamoguna is more in the in such patients, and then that's why they become lazy, that's why they become sedentary, that's why they like all sorts of sweets and junk foods and all sort of things. Like this, they like, there is a sort of covering on their brain. They don't understand. We call it as prajnapara. So this, we need to take care of the psychological aspect of this these patients, and you need to counsel them frequently during their treatment. This is an important approach of treatment. Now, having said that, I would also like to suggest some simple home remedies, which are the safe medicines which anybody can take. In spite of, irrespective of their type, whether they are from 20 types, whether it is kaphaja, pittaja or vataja, or whether it is type 1 or type 2 or gestational diabetes, any type, they can take these three safe medicines. Every diabetic, on the contrary, should take these three medicines. The one is Trifala. It is a very, all over the globe, this medicine is available. You can even buy from Amazon, and it's a very safe medicine. It is actually used as a laxative, but it is not habit forming. It is a rasayana herb. It says that yam rasayana vara trifala akshamaya paha rupani tvat gadakleda medomeha kafastrachit. It's a very beautiful drug, and it actually everyone can take it every day, and for a long time you can take it. It's very safe. It contains only three herbs. It's a purely herbal combination, and every diabetic should take this. Then the another thing is the turmeric and amla. Amla is the Indian gooseberry. If you don't get amla, you can get it actually, the juice of amla and turmeric is readily available. It is a household actually substance which is used in Indian cooking. So this half a teaspoonful of turmeric and 1 teaspoonful of amla powder, or 2 teaspoonful of amla juice, if you get, and half a teaspoonful of turmeric is a good combination. It acts as a medicine for diabetes. It also acts as a rejuvenative tonic. It also acts as an antioxidant, and it has many benefits. It will definitely keep you away from the complications if you already have diabetes. If you are pre-diabetes, we have a very good research going on in our institute, which tells that the pre-diabetic patients are cured of their condition and they are not converted into diabetes due to the use of turmeric for 90 days. So this is a very good thing. You can also, turmeric is also, and amla is also a substance which you can use for a long time, and there is absolutely no. Another herb I would like to introduce, and which is especially in picture in these COVID times, and which is called as giloy or guruchi or amrita. The name of this herb in Ayurveda is called as amrita. That means that the one which doesn't allow the cells to die. Chronic aging and chronic inflammation is the biggest pathology that happens in diabetes, and this herb prevents precisely that aging and inflammatory process in the cellular level. So this is very important. Now, when we the question was asked about the fake carbohydrates. I mean, there is a lot of information over the fake carb. By fake carbohydrates, I mean it is the artificial sweeteners that are used. There are many, aspartame, then stevia, and many things. What I want to suggest is that if you miss your sweets too much, it is okay to use a little bit or sometimes. But please don't use this in cooking, because it's loses its properties while cooking. So don't use in the place of sugar. Only a little bit should be used. And fake carbohydrates or artificial sweeteners, as they are called, they are like a lot of study has been done. They are not harmful, but it is always better to be stay natural and to restrict the use as minimum as possible. So the in Ayurveda, there is a stage-wise treatment of diabetes is treated. There are six stages. Actually, Sushrut Sanhita has very elaborately explained the treatment of diabetes. There is one group of patients which are prone to diabetes. Pramehi Bhavishyati. They are not yet diabetic. They are not pre-diabetic. There is a tendency of people, obese people, people who have history of diabetes in the family, heavy eaters, sedentary lifestyle, those who people are who like to gulp on sweets, these are the people who are prone to diabetes according to Ayurveda. These people also need to be watchful for their habits and their diet and their activities so that they don't proceed. Now, these are the three stages. Every person goes from these stages, from stage 1 to stage 6 at some point of time in his life. And the goal of the treatment should be, or the goal of the patient also should be, to stay as much as possible in the same stage or to go back, but not to try and avoid the progression of diabetes in this system. So the second group is pre-diabetes, that is having HbA1c more between 5.7 to 6.4. Then frank diabetic patients who have HbA1c more than 6.5, and chronic diabetes, like diabetes for more than 3 to 5 years, they start to show different symptoms and the different signs. Then there are comes the group which called as diabetic with complications, with one or more complications. And then the another group is a group of patients who so these are the group of patients who are with severe comorbidities. The patient vulnerable, and the diabetes has grown to a great extent. From number 1 to number 6, the pathology of the diabetes, pathogenesis of this disease is more and more, and it gets complicated, and it is very difficult to eradicate this disease at late stages. It is very easy to eradicate this disease till 1, 2 and 3 stages. But from 4 onwards, it becomes difficult, more and more difficult. So in a group, I would like to, you know, this is for the doctors, basically, what kind of treatment is planned according to Ayurveda. First stage, we have to give to reduce their weight. It is called as apadarpan treatment, that which reduce their medha, which reduce their kapha in their body. The such kind of treatment is available in Ayurveda. Unfortunately, we don't have sufficient time to elaborate on each and every aspect. But in pre-diabetes, you can give, there are 10 different medicines described for each diabetes that you can use. In the second stage, the treatment where goes adding on. As the treatment, the disease becomes complicated, you need the treatment of medicines also becomes more and more complex, and you have to use multiple things at the same time. So in a way, this is a called of sort of treatment approach that is given. I would just like to give the stage-wise progression, what Sushruta has said, that at this treatment, if the stage is not done, the person continues having sweets and the diet, then urine becomes sweat and urine becomes sweet, and kapha is sweetened, and the diabetes become conspicuous, and the person is diagnosed as diabetes. I have straight taken you to the third stage because I don't want to burden you with too much of technical information. But at this stage, you need to advise patients, the Vamana and Virechana, at this time of treatment. Then if you don't do this, if you fail, if you miss this chance, then the pathogenesis progresses, and there is a condition which causes microinflammation. Now, this microinflammation is the real culprit which damages all organs in the body and all cells of the body. This is the thing that we need to watch. This is an important aspect that the physician should also tell. And this is very, unfortunately, it is very inconspicuous. A simple test of C-reactive protein should be done. If the C-reactive protein values are increasing, that you can understand that there is microinflammation going on in the body, and you need to take the disease very seriously, and you need to accordingly add the treatment and medicines. Ayurveda has got very nice medicines to contain the microinflammation. Diet plays a great role. Like if you remember, Dr. Abhishek Kumar has advised that against the use of curd and yogurts. The curd and yogurts enhances the microinflammation to such an extent that it progresses the disease very fast. So it is very important to avoid curd and yogurt totally. Another thing I would like to advise is that people are very health conscious, and wellness, there is an inclination to increase wellness. So they try to go to the gym. When they try to go to the gym, they go to the spa. Now, taking steam is severely contraindicated for diabetic patients, because that increases the microinflammation, that increases the amount of fluids in the body, and the progression of disease becomes very fast. So diabetic patients are advised not to take any kind of fermentation whatsoever in nature. Neither dry, nor spa, nor sauna, nothing sort of is advised, and they should refrain. That's a very important type, part of advice. Now, if the microinflammation increases, then at this time, the organ-specific abnormalities like tissue damage, diabetic food, carbuncles, nephropathies, retinopathies, atherosclerosis, all start to set in, and then the surgical intervention becomes necessary. And then if you still don't do the right treatment at that stage, then you come to a condition called sepsis and ketoacidosis, and at this time of thin, and there hit the patients become really vulnerable at this stage. So the other thing which I will not repeat this, only other things which I want to is that carbohydrate rich foods should be avoided. And I would like to take your attention to the foods with excess fluids. Like people eat watermelons and all sorts of melons all over the year. Now that is a thing which is not recommended. Anything that increases fluids in the body, that increases fats in the body, like butter, cheese, paneer and all sort of thing, I mean cottage cheese, all these things are completely contraindicated according to Ayurveda. This part is an important part. This should not be missed. So that's why I would like to highlight that. So these are the, we have repeated. Now, what are the factors that we are consider, that we consider in the treatment? This is the fluid excess that we need to concentrate in the treatment. The metabolic factors, the macro digestion happening at the level of intestines, the micro digestion happening at the level of tissues, and the micro, super micro level of digestion happening at the level of organs and panchamahabhutas is very important. Now, lipid metabolism is a part, important part of Ayurvedic line of treatment. So that's why you find every diabetic patient eventually has dyslipidemia, that is abnormal cholesterol levels. And unless and until you correct the dyslipidemia, your treatment of diabetes cannot be successful. Now, the loosened muscles. So actually going to the gym and doing the cardio work and the weights and all is very useful for diabetic patients. It increases.
Dr. Abhay, I request you to please reach to the main conclusion. Keeping the time in mind.
Yes, sure. I'll be finishing in 5 minutes.
Thank you.
If you allow. Yeah. I'm almost to the end of my presentation. Thank you very much. So the group of people, we divide the group of obese diabetics and lean diabetics, and we deal with them differently according to Ayurveda. And these are the, for the interest of all everybody, I have listed about 22 herbs which are commonly used. I won't recommend each and everyone to use this, because this should be used in the under the supervision of the Vaidya only. So Ayurveda has described Atidesh Chikitsa, which means the treatment of skin diseases, lipid metabolism, corrective medicines, obesity, and other many more medicines. So this makes the spectrum of medicines, a wide spectrum of medicines are available for diabetes in Ayurveda, and it can be handled in a very nice way. So the last part is that Ayurveda has given even the criteria. When the urine of diabetic patients become clear, transparent, and of bitter and pungent in taste, that means the sugar becomes absent, then these patients become healthy and free from diabetes. So these are the things that we consider according to Ayurveda in the treatment of diabetes. And with this slide, I come to the end of my presentation. I once again thank all of the participants for a patient listening and cooperation of my panelists. And again, I thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to present my thoughts before all of you. Thank you, and all of you, please stay safe and take care of your health. See you soon. Goodbye. Namaste.
Thank you very much, Dr. Abhay Kulkarni. Could I request Dr. Gagandeep Ji to kindly take on, please?
Yeah, sure, sir. I hope I am audible to everyone.
You are audible perfectly.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. So, hello, everyone. Or I should say, in this Corona call, humble namaskar to everyone, to all my seniors. And I can actually define this in a more fine manner, saying the Namo Gange Namaskar, which I read in the message sent to me by Mr. Anshul Agarwal ji. And I really like this. So, Namo Gange Namaskar to everyone. और पूरे भारत, पूरे वर्ल्ड, पूरे यूनिवर्स को नमो गंगे और नमस्कार, जिसमें हम हाथ जोड़ना सीख गए हैं. इट्स रियली अप्रिशिएट. सो एंड हैप्पी टीचर्स डे टू ऑल माय सीनियर्स, ऑल माय गुरुज, ऑल द प्रोफेसर्स हियर, ऑल द पैनलिस्ट. एंड इट इज अ ग्रेट प्लेजर फॉर मी टू शेयर द सेम प्लेटफॉर्म विद सो मच सीनियर्स. एंड आई थिंक इट वॉज अ लर्निंग इवनिंग फॉर मी. Dr. Abhishek ji, Dr. Abhishek Srivastav, Dr. Abhay Kulkarni ji, very nice presentation, sir. It is really appreciable. And I once again thank all the members, Dr. Gulshan Sharma ji, for starting in such a positive way. You know, from that, I was, before listening to you, I was actually making some of the chits and papers, because I have not been told about the presentation. But after you have said go natural way, I have kept everything aside. So it is really appreciable you have boosted me. So sharing some of the aspects which Dr. Abhishek Sharma has said and Dr. Abhay Kulkarni ji, with regard to them, I have a little bit elaborate that thing in my point of view, which a little bit of my learning. So according to me, diabetes, actually it is not a disease. We have to follow this. It is, as we nowadays, world is saying that it is a lifestyle disorder. And I feel proud to say that our Maharishis, our, you know, Rishis, Maharishis already, they have elaborated this is a lifestyle disorder only. So when I was completing my certificate in diabetic mellitus from the Royal Liverpool United Kingdoms, it was actually, I'm sharing my personal experience in their slide. They have the second slide in their overall video conferences and their video teachings, where I have clicked one of this paper from the printout. They have this, the picture of the Charak, Maharishi Charak. And it said, ki Charak around 200 BC observed the difference between thin people who developed Madhumeha. In that scenario, 5,000 years back, they have explained type 1 and type 2. And hats off to them. And they are the actual teachers for us. We are just implementing what we have taught from them for the Granthas and Samhitas. So it said, observe different between thin people who develop Madhumeha at a younger age and obese subjects who develop the conditions at an older age. So this shows the type 1 and type 2 diabetes. So this is one aspect. Coming to my topic of lifestyle changes and you know, micronutrients and taking care of your diet. I think in Ayurveda, medicines have the third place, not only in diabetes, in everything, in every disease. From a simple cold cough flu to diabetes to cancer to corona, we have simple lifestyle changes are the must thing which have to be adopted. So medicines has to be the last thing. And I have been working on this and I have seen the great results. So, and one thing more I would like to share here, maybe all the listeners who are listening globally, they should get to know Ayurveda is not the form of medication we should follow. It is a form of the life, lifestyle we should follow. Because Ayurveda to me, it is my religion. I live Ayurveda. I try to teach my patients to live with Ayurveda. So this is the lifestyle. So basically that maybe we can say, I'm not presenting my presentation, but I would like to start that sweet is must for diabetes. Because according to Ayurveda, maintaining or balancing the dhatus which built the human system is the most important part of the diabetes. Seven dhatus we know, it is ras, rag, mas, med, asthi, majja and shukra. So it starts with rasa dhatu. So maybe rasa means the plasma for the global listeners. I may explain it a little bit. And rakta is the blood, masa is the muscles, med is the fats, asthi is the bones, and majja is the bone marrow, and shukra is the reproductive tissues. So we have to maintain all this. So starting with the rasa, so in Ayurveda, Dr. Abhishek also told we have six rasas for a taste of our tongue. And first start with the prime rasa is the sweet, madhu. So madhur, lavan, amul, katu, tikt, kashaya. That is sweet, salty, sour, pungent, and bitter, astringent. So we can't ignore consuming the madhur rasa. It is really important for every diabetic patient to consume the natural source of madhur rasa. As Dr. Abhay Kulkarni told that the artificial carbohydrates is not at all recommended. And if I'm talking about the sweet is must for diabetes, I mean the natural form of sweets, which is in the form of jaggery, gud, milk, ghee, wheat, rice, and other grains, maybe fruits, dates, honey. These all are very much advisable. Other than sugar, other than using or maybe chemical generated sugar-free tablets and rest of the things which spoil overall system and which weakens the metabolism. So we should follow the natural form of sweets. It is really very much for sweet. So secondly, I want to explain here, without changing the lifestyle, we can't overcome the complications of the diabetes, whether we are taking any form of medication. So I actually advise my tagline to all the listeners, and it is, I have written, started writing a book on this, ki pehle nahana hai aur phir khana hai. I have done so a little bit of the maybe 5-6 webinars in this lockdown. So if I have spoken on the lifestyle disorders, I have spoken on the liver diseases, I have spoken on the obesity. So pehle nahana hai aur fir khana hai, ye bahut zaruri hai. It is daily must. So in this lockdown also, we have started, we are sleeping late, we are getting up late, we are taking bath in the afternoon. This is the first step we are doing wrong. So as it increases the kapha in our body and our overall body, blood circulation get disturbed. We get weak physically, we get dull mentally. So we have to take care of not only from the hygienic point of view, but from the digestion point of view. Let me tell you one thing. If one is doing exercise, this is really appreciable. But we have to educate everyone. Taking bath is an exercise. After taking bath, we get warm up. After taking bath, our blood circulation gets better. Our digestion gets better. So, pehle nahana hai aur phir khana hai. It is the first thing. Secondly, about talking about the meals, we should have our meals on time. It should be fixed like the military generals, like the army people. Where we have to take care of our meals in that way. We can't ignore our eating habits. If in Ayurveda we say, if we are taking the wrong diet, then medicine is of no use. If we are taking the right diet, then medicine is of no need at all. So I was reading somewhere and it really attracted me, taking the chemical drugs like metformin. I have to mention this because being a doctor, it's my duty to educate everyone. We are going for the different kind of tests and we are advised to do tests for vitamin B12 these days. And every diabetic patient who is having the metformin drug, his or her vitamin B12 will be less because taking metformin can reduce the B12 in our body. So it is really harmful. So maybe we should switch to some kind of natural medications from the very beginning. And believe me, we have so wonderful results without giving much of strong medicines. Dr. Abhay Kulkarni has given the wonderful slideshow and showing the plenty of Ayurvedic herbs, Ayurvedic medicines, which do miracle results in different to different and difficult to difficult complications of the Ayurveda for related complications of the diabetes or madhumeha. But let me tell you, he has mentioned the haldi, turmeric. The main part of the haldi is the curcumin, which is used in the diabetic patients. We are giving the part of the curcumin, and only curcumin is actually, we are seeing the reversal of the diabetes in the patients who have not taken a single day of the chemical drug. They have been reversed. I will not say the patients who have been on the chemical drug because they get their system so much dependent upon the chemical drugs. It is difficult task to make them reverse. But if they follow the Ayurveda system of life, Ayurveda system of diet, Ayurveda system of living. And here I would like to add one thing, Mr. Dr. Gulshan Sharmaji was saying at the beginning about the sessions he is taking on Sundays, telling people about the sar of the Gitas. I believe medical system, whether it is Ayurveda or anything, and spiritualism cannot be differentiated. They both go side by side. And I share with my patients when we are into colleges of Ayurveda, we are taught that we should give our patients medicine, thinking that we are giving medicine to our son. So we will never give the wrong medicine if you think like that. So I would like to mention here, medicine has the third place. First is your routine. Second is your precaution. And third is the medicine. So if we are not fully fulfilling the first two steps, we will not be able to have the maximum benefit of the medicines. So dinacharya, the routine, the lifestyle, the eating habits, timely routine are the key steps to overcome any complication of the diabetes. Secondly, so here I want to add ki we see all the patients of diabetes mellitus, they end up with the renal failure. Dr. Abhay Kulkarni was saying he is dealing with the nephropathy as well. And yes, we see every diabetic patient is ending up with the renal failure and at the end, they have to go for the dialysis. There is no option. Let me tell you two important things here. Actually, diabetes or maybe a little bit on the higher side diabetes does not cause these kind of renal failures. It is the drug reaction. It is the ADR factor, adverse drug reaction, which is making the renal failures. So you have to be really careful about taking maybe single therapy drugs, dual therapy drugs, or triple therapy drugs, adding the insulin. They have the adverse drug reaction. That is the reason patients are ending their life with the renal failure, and then on dialysis, it is really harmful for their life. So, and the most important factor here is one as well, the diabetes medicines which are being prescribed for long-term use, they not only make the system weak, pancreas weak, but they overall make the immune system of the patient weak. The natural secretion of the insulin, natural working of the pancreas, if a person, a strong person, gets the injury in maybe legs, if he is told to sit on the wheelchair to heal the injury, it may take a longer time. And if he is told to keep a natural walk or maybe natural healing and try to walk little bit daily, the blood circulation gets normal naturally. So giving the wheelchair to the patient to heal, it's a problem. The body will get in a habit of the wheelchair. So what I'm trying to say, we should not get habitual to any kind of harmful drug. Lifestyle changes are must scenario of the diabetes. So one thing more, I believe diabetes is not a disease, but an imbalance of the whole human system. So we have to follow this. We have to work on the diet and the nutrition. And the nutrition is the most challenging part of the diabetes management. And I think the most ignored as well. The various factor affects the individual recommendation according to Ayurveda. It is never, I would say no one size fits for all. Any recommendation, if I am saying from the webinar, if I am speaking any word, it has to be universal. So I have to be limited to my words, because in diabetes, all the Vaidyas, when we are treating 5 patients of diabetes, we don't prescribe the same medicines to everyone. We have to see their bulb, we have to see their body type, we have to see their vata, pitta, and kapha. We have to, according to their this thing, according to constitution of their body, we advise the medicine. And we see whether we have to give the medicines or not, or whether we just have to advise them the lifestyle changes. So the value of the food and nutrition is very much important. Weight management actually prevent or delay the diabetes-related complications. So if we do regular exercises or vyama, regular, maybe we are taking care of dinacharya, it can definitely prevent or delay the diabetes-related complications. And in the cases who have not taken the allopathic chemicals at all, as I have discussed earlier, we are seeing the cases of the reversal as well, because it is possible with Ayurveda. So eating a pattern of micronutrients and natural form of carbohydrates, it's really good. Refined sugar must be replaced with natural source such as grains, legumes, vegetables, fruits, and even jaggery. And sugar sweetened beverages, processed food containing high amount of refined grains and added sugar should be avoided. An individual with diabetes kidney disease is the most important to know, because daily recommendation is, see, we have to understand this when we are talking about the kidney patients. We have to see, because in kidney patient, the daily recommendation of the protein is 0.8 grams per kilogram body weight. And nowadays, as youngsters go to gym, they are recommended about the whey protein. I am talking about the causes why people are getting diabetes these days in a very early age. Artificial source of protein can also become a burden on your kidneys. So one has to be really very careful about this thing. And as I have discussed earlier, vitamin B12 supplementation may be required in patients on metformin. Because the regular use of metformin, a patient gets deficient in B12. So we have to be careful again. Now talking on the lifestyle changes, alcoholism should be avoided totally. Because see, when some people say moderate consumption is fine, I don't know why, but it is the beginning of the problem. So we should, being a doctor, should not advise a moderate or less consumption. It is equal to excessive consumption, I believe. Maybe if we say something sour is not advisable for throat, taking a half teaspoon of ketchup can also aggravate the disease. So moderate or excessive alcoholism should be avoided totally, because liver is in a danger when one is having diabetes. So we have to take care of the liver, because it has a chances to get fatty liver. Maybe someone alcoholic fatty liver is a common disease. So we have to be very careful. So, and globally, if we are talking, we have to know the scenario of the mortality rates. And I would like to mention one thing: we should not get in a rat race of getting our sugar down with the medicine. Maybe Ayurveda. Ayurveda does not get the sugar down immediately, because it maintains, it improves your metabolism, it works on the immune system. But I want to clear this chapter to my all the viewers and all the patients who are suffering from diabetes. We should not run over this, that our diabetes should get controlled with excessive medicines. I say to my patients, little bit diabetes on the higher side is your strength. So you have to be really careful. Lower diabetes, because the mortality rate is because of maximum mortality rate is because of hypoglycemia. It is because of the low blood sugar. So maintaining little bit higher blood sugar is nowhere an issue at all. Throughout the life, you can lead a normal life, but insisting doctor or maybe taking a burden of this, we should take much of medicines and our sugar should get low. This is actually harmful for the individuals. So globally, one person dies every 6 seconds due to diabetes. So we have to be careful. And approximately 12% of the global healthcare expenditure is dependent upon the diabetes. So diabetes is the topic which is not to be missed. And I really appreciate the platform of the Namo Gange and ICSI, who have taken this initiative of taking the Ayurveda to the global world, where in our Honorable Prime Minister has already made the immunity card, which have been explained by the Ayush Ministry, so much global, ki every person coming to us is first asking for the card. So I really thanks the Ayush Ministry, the ICSI, the Namo Gange Trust, to taking this platform globally to know that Ayurveda is not just the form of medication. Yes, it is the form of medication because it cures the problem with the roots, but it is the lifestyle. And ending my words, Ayurveda and spiritualism go side by side. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Gagandeep Singh ji. Very kind of you. May I now extend a very warm invitation. The lady has waited patiently that long. We have got Dr. Ramya Krishnan ji to kindly share her thought process and what's our view. I have not disturbed and stopped any speaker because I want people to be benefited, humanity to be benefited, but at the same time, all of us, we got to keep the time factor also in mind. Initially, a lot of time has been taken by people. So Dr. Ramya, please do the justice with your subject. Take your time.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Namaste all. Actually, it's my pleasure and privilege today to share the platform with all of you. And Dr. Gulshan Sharma, sir, I thank you. I come to know that you are a Director General of International Chamber of Service Industry. It's my pleasure and honor to share the platform with you, sir. And also the organizers of Namo Gange Trust, and Dr. Piyush Juneja ji, who had recommended me for this program. So with all your permission, I'm directly going to the PowerPoint. Before going to PowerPoint, I would like to let you know that this presentation is for the public more than doctors. So you cannot expect any technical things more here in my presentation. Okay. So with that introduction, I'm going to the presentation. Thank you. So I hope it is visible and I'm audible also.
It is there, ma'am, and you are audible also. Both the things are perfectly fine. Please go ahead.
Okay, thank you. So here the topic of my presentation is SBEBA. As you might have seen in my introduction, SBEBA curative strategies in type 2 diabetes mellitus for masses. So you might be wondering what this SBEBA is. So it is science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda. So science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda is, in one word, it is scientifically cultured and updated Ayurveda. And it incorporates inbuilt science-led evidences what are the signs led? In Ayurveda, there are two types of evidences. One is the data-led evidence, which is outbuilt, and the primary evidence is science-led evidence, like based on what logic in science you are treating this particular condition of this particular patient. That is well described in the science of Ayurveda. So choosing that particular logic and applying it to diagnosis and treatment, that is what is called science-led evidence, which it is very crucial in determining the prognosis of treatment done by an Ayurveda physician. So science-led evidence-based strategies for diagnosis and management of diseases are for the first time introduced by myself and my husband, Dr. Rajkumar, who are the pioneers of SBEBA innovation in Ayurveda, which emerged in 2012. For the first time, we have initiated specific and specialized diagnostic and treatment strategies to diagnose and all the novel diseases, like all the metabolic diseases, inflammatory diseases, infective diseases, all types of modern diseases, hormonal disorders, how to understand in Ayurvedic perspective on the target and how they can be managed by applying the Ayurvedic decision-making guidelines. This we have done research for more than 10 years, and I will say nearly 15 years. And afterwards, we have published it in 3 of our publications, and we are treating innumerable number of patients and training Ayurveda doctors also. So coming to diabetes also, we have done this research intensely. So diabetes is a metabolic disorder characterized by complex alterations, as we all know, in glucose, protein, and lipid metabolism. Metabolic error, just understand that diabetes is not born in a day. It is a metabolic error which is sustained for years. You are not getting, when you check your blood sugar only, you come to know that you are having type 2 diabetes, but it was born in a couple of days or months or years. Beta cell dysfunction might be there for years before hyperglycemia manifests. Type 2 diabetes is largely a man-made disease because it is created by erroneous lifestyle and food habits owing to altered metabolism in cells caused largely by insulin resistance. Even though insulin is produced, cells are unable to use up glucose. Insulin sensitization is badly affected in target tissues like smooth muscles, and fat depots, and also liver. So actually insulin functional deficit is happening, okay. So insulin resistance means poor metabolism in cells. Metabolism is the crucial component of the diabetes. Poor metabolism in cells, decreased efficiency of the liver by certain diseases of the liver, maybe it is primary or secondary disease, or certain medications, or sustained inflammation in cells. You know, sustain any sort of inflammation sustaining in the cells. Even infection can cause inflammation. Autoimmune disorders can cause inflammation. Some drugs can cause inflammation. Some diets can cause inflammation. Wrong diets in infection and inflammation can cause chronic inflammation. So sustained inflammation can slow down metabolism and it can initiate insulin resistance. The cells of muscles and fat tissues are poorly sensitized to insulin in the case of insulin resistance. And the problem is that they are unable to assimilate glucose and perform other anabolic functions. So insulin resistance is compensated by the body by hyperinsulinemia. So insulin secretion will be high. Along with that, hyperglycemia will also exist. And chronic hyperglycemia further suppresses the beta cell function and worsens the insulin resistance. So science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda, which is proposed, devised and developed by us, these are the curative goals. I repeat, it is like most of the patients who are reaching us are able to get a cure by science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda. So these are the curative goals. Stimulation of metabolism in the cells is the primary goal of SBEBA. Make the insulin targets active and efficient in improving insulin sensitivity and thus facilitate uptake and metabolism. Improving hepatic responsiveness and reversing fat-induced metabolic stress by improving the efficiency of the liver. That is another thing, because fat-induced metabolic stress can affect the liver and it can adversely affect the hepatic responsiveness also, and reversing insulin resistance by, this is very specific to SBEBA, intrinsic cause-oriented approach naturally reverses the chances of complications. I'm coming to that. So what is this intrinsic cause-oriented approach? Every diabetic patient is different. The cause which initiates diabetes, type 2 diabetes, in each and every patient is different. So these can be the variable causes. In certain people, it is because of unused fat stores by unscientific diet and sedentary life. The public who are in front of me, they might be thinking what cause. They can analyze themselves. What could be the possible cause? If diabetic patients are there, they can analyze themselves. In certain other people, sustained inflammation in cells, those who are having sustained inflammation, so it could be silent inflammation or it could be all the inflammatory signs like pain, swelling, redness, etc. may or may not be present. But in muscle swelling, muscle inflammation, no symptoms may be present other than pain. So all these slow down metabolism and initiates type 2 diabetes. Sometimes it could be drug induced like steroids. As you know, corticosteroids, many of the patients who have approached me have the history of corticosteroid induced diabetes. And in some other people, factors antagonistic to liver function. It can be anything starting from paracetamol. Paracetamol and NSAIDs. Nowadays, people are consuming too many painkillers. All these can alter liver function and easily facilitate the chances of getting type 2 diabetes apart from other immune dysfunction disorders. Hence, ICOA, that is intrinsic cause-oriented approach, exactly what causes initiating diabetes, we are exploring by Ayurvedic principles and we are trying to reverse it. This is what is being developed by SBABA. So goals of SBABA management: to reverse diabetes in patients of curable prognosis, to reverse the onset and progress of diabetes complications. Of course, when there is no diabetes, there is no complication at all. So we don't need to treat for complications separately, right? When we are reversing diabetes, no question of complications. To enable diabetic patients of incurable status to maintain. Of course, there are certain group of patients who are incurable for diabetes, which is estimated by Ayurvedic prognostic guidelines criteria. To maintain healthy life. So what we can do in them, we can try to maintain healthy life and quality life and increase their life expectancy by most minimum medicine. So this is one biggest advantage of science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda in relation to conventional Ayurveda guidelines. So what we have developed is, we have developed certain strategies by means of which the patients will require most minimum. I will say fragments of tablet, like pinches of tablet, and scientific nutrition schedule of SBABA. So these are the curative strategies. So first thing, there are two factors responsible for the onset of diabetes. One is insulin resistance. So what do SBABA guidelines do? First thing, it is for easy understanding. I made it in layman's language. Activating true appetite. You know, there is false appetite also. Sometimes diabetic patients will be very much hungry all the time. I didn't mean that. A physician, an SBABA practitioner can differentiate what is true and what is fake. So activating true appetite reduces unused glucose in circulation and improves insulin entry into the cells. So this is the one strategy. And there is science-led weight loss program. I'll be explaining that also. And second one, science-led weight loss program reverses fatty liver and reverses insulin resistance. Reduction of free fatty acids, which causes inflammation and insulin resistance. So when free fatty acids are reduced, inflammation will be reduced and insulin resistance is improved. So this is what activating true appetite and science-led weight loss program. These two factors improve insulin resistance. Not only improve, it will reverse insulin resistance. This is what is being observed in clinical practice. And second is beta cell function. First, we are giving medication for metabolism boosting. Medication means it will be classical Ayurveda medicine, but in the most minimum dosage. You cannot imagine such a dosage. It will be in pinches that it will be administered, not even in tablets. One tablet, two tablets. It will be one pinches, two pinches, etc. Maybe one third of a tablet per day. The classical medicine is chosen by science-based evidences after evaluation of the cause, state, and stage of the patient. And that metabolism medication will reduce the strain for beta cells naturally and improve their efficiency. And second, these are not hypotheses. These are all proven and established by clinical research also. Mobilizing excess fat by metabolism rectifies beta cell dysfunction. So medication to improve beta cell function is another step. It will be done in the second stage. So metabolism medication will improve improve beta cell function, and mobilizing excess fat by metabolism will also improve beta cell function. Apart from that, in the second stage, I'll be coming to that, we will be giving medication to improve beta cell function directly. That is in the second stage. So as I told, SBEBA curative strategies are for two phases. It is done in two phases. Okay. Phase one, when the patient is approaching us in any form, whether it be by oral hypoglycemic drugs, or sometimes with insulin alone, or sometimes without any drugs, whatever it is, what we are doing first, 7 to 14 days, activating appetite and losing weight. Overweight individuals, we have to lose weight. Scientific weight loss program, I'll be explaining that on SBEBA. And second step, medication for metabolism. This stage will be completed in 7 to 14 days. Don't think that diabetes has to be taken lifelong. What we are telling by SBEBA curative strategies, phase one, after phase one, you just check FBS before treatment, and after 7 days you repeat. And I mean, those who have learned SBEBA will understand the difference. And afterwards, in the end of second week, you can ensure that blood sugar, FBS is completely normal. Not only that, reduction in body fat in obese patients, onset of good, natural, timely appetite, lightness and enthusiasm will be observed in all the patients. Attainment of normal blood sugar levels without any chemical drugs or insulin. In the first visit itself, an SBEBA practitioner will be stopping all the anti-diabetic and all the drugs which are used for diabetes, including and also insulin. Okay. So phase one, boosting appetite. How boosting appetite is done? It is very simple but very important. By sipping very hot medicated water intermittently, water boiled with fresh stem of Tinospora cordifolia. It is called guluchi in Sanskrit and giloy in Hindi. So very hot medicated water. Actually, you have to boil the stem itself, not leaves. Stem, fresh stem. It has to be taken about 2 inches length. Peel, crush and boil in water. You must have the habit of drinking boiled water. First of all, unboiled water, there are scientific evidences in Ayurveda which substantiate the fact that unboiled water will slow down metabolism. Okay, so it is really important to drink boiled water, that too hot medicated water. Medicated water is very important, that too right medication, as I mentioned, and it has to be taken. And other times you can go for drinking boiled medicated water at normal temperature. But you have to sip hot medicated water. Heavy eating, overeating, frequent eating and eating a mixed diet. Nowadays there is a trend like some rice, after that some chapati, or it's like thali meals, how you eat. It is called Bhojana Sangara. It is a mixed diet. Mixed diet is unscientific diet. Heavy eating, you are eating full stomach, whether it be low calorie or high calorie. If you are eating heavily, that is called heavy eating. Overeating, like excess quantity eating, frequent eating before the previous meal is digested, you are eating again. You are having a feeling of tiredness. You think that it is because of hunger that I am tired, and you are eating slow, small proportions of food frequently. And mixed unscientific diet. All these can suppress natural appetite and slow down metabolism. Understand that if you are doing all this, it's really important to know that it has to be stopped. Recommended exercises by SBEBA include jogging. If you do yoga, that is fine for you. Postural exercises are all good. But if you want to improve your metabolism, you will have to do jogging, stair climbing. You do stair climbing or playing badminton for 30 minutes. Any of these or all of this mixed together, no problem. But it should be done in empty stomach morning and evening. No daytime rest or sleep is intended for a diabetic or pre-diabetic patient who is actively sleeping at night. Okay, unless night duty is there. Scientific weight loss program includes vegan diet, devoid of milk and milk products, fats, all oil, ghee, butter, all the fats are to be cut off. nuts, fruits, and dry fruits. All these can stimulate, all these can slow down metabolism and they can stimulate inflammation, for which Ayurvedic scientific evidences are there. That's why I'm telling you, we are practicing science-based, evidence-based medicine. So we are having science-based evidences to substantiate why and how nuts, fruits, and dry fruits are dangerous for diabetic patients. They can stimulate inflammation and they can slow down metabolism. Fermented foods like idli, dosa, especially South Indians and North Indians take so much of curd and other fermented foods of many kinds. All kinds of sour ingredients, amla rasa, sour ingredients, it can trigger inflammation. Abhishyandi, technical term is abhishyandi. It can stimulate inflammation and it can impair metabolism. And most important thing that we adopt in phase one of SBEBA guideline is one medicine to stimulate metabolism that we decide after examining the patient and his comorbidities and what all diseases he is more susceptible to. That also we explore and we decide that one medicine. Only one medicine is used in phase one to stimulate metabolism along with scientific diet and medicated water. And phase two, so I told you within 1 to 2 weeks, blood sugar, fasting blood sugar will be normal and patient will be showing lightness, enthusiasm, active fat reduction will happen. It's not necessary that weight will reduce very fast. Fat reduction is a good sign, especially in overweight individuals. Medicated ghee treatment will be adopted in phase two. Medicated ghee means ghee processed with Ayurvedic medicine. So there are classical medicated ghees explained in Ayurvedic medical treatises based on the patient's cause, state, stage, etc. We are choosing which ghee. Only one ghee is chosen to stabilize metabolism and improves beta cell function strictly under the expert guidance and monitoring of an SBEBA practitioner. So conventional Ayurveda practice is different. So it should be under complete instructions of a learned and practically trained SBEBA practitioner that it should be adopted. Strict scientific nutrition schedule of SBEBA, Snehapana Pathya itself with specific modification in accordance to patient will be made. And what are the expected outcome after phase two? Metabolic and immune stabilization with stable blood sugar levels maintained without any antiandrogenic drugs. See, in phase two, we are not giving anything to stimulate metabolism. We are not giving anything to improve beta cell like directly. We are giving medicated ghee to improve the beta cell function. We are not giving any anti-diabetic dravyas or turmeric or anything like amalaki or anything. We are not giving anything. We are producing metabolic boosting in the first stage and metabolic stabilization in the second stage without any antiandrogenic drugs of any system. And reversal of comorbidities, if any. So this is the greatest advantage of SBEBA when a patient is undergoing phase two. Suppose he is having any comorbidities like dyslipidemia, hypothyroidism, etc. Phase one, we will be concentrating on that also. We are having specific guidelines to integrate multiple pathologies and deal with one medicine scientific diet approach. That is the success of our research. And stage two, we can reverse comorbidities also along with this diabetes. So this is the greatest success of science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda. All grace, all the blessings from God and this science. So phase two, hospital admission is generally required for phase two because 10 days will be required and regular monitoring and supervision will be required in the spirit. Only internal medicine and no other procedures, no panchakarma is required in this. No panchakarma is required in diabetes mellitus as per SBEBA guidelines. Okay, only this, what I have explained is needed. Only internal medicine and no other procedures are required for any patients. Strict adoption of instructions from SBEBA practitioner in medication, diet and regimen. So why SBEBA in type 2 diabetes? Reversal of type 2 diabetes in curative prognostic standards. That is possible. Reversal of comorbidities. As I told, if the patient is having metabolic and inflammatory kind of disorders, hypertension or vascular morbidities, all this will be rectified by SBABA stage-wise treatment, and it also improves the functions of heart, brain, liver, and kidney naturally. One medicine scientific diet approach. We are not prescribing a prescription loaded by medicines. We are just prescribing fragments of one medicine, scientific diet and medicated water. On the target, results are quick and evident, both in body as well as in lab. It makes you confident. Patient. It makes you confident to take up your own responsibility of reversing your diseases. So with your permission, I am sharing one patient experience who had undergone. He was having multiple diseases, and with diabetes he was.
Is it a video, ma'am? Is it a video? Ma'am, is it video? Madam, is it video? It's not coming. It's not coming, madam. It's not coming.
Not coming?
No. If it's a video, then you're just sharing the link or you're playing the video.
Can you help me, sir? I am trying for that.
No. You want to just show the link or you want to play?
Yeah, I want to share the video actually. It's not coming?
No, it's not coming. Anyway.
I'm sorry. I'm trying for that.
No worries. No worries, ma'am. We can proceed.
Why it's not coming?
No worries.
You are able to hear the voice?
No, ma'am. It's not coming.
No, okay, fine.
I think...
What happened?
Now the video has come, but there's no voice.
Help me.
The audio is not there. Audio is not there.
Is it visible?
It is visible, but there's no audio.
Okay, then ma'am, I will stop. Yeah.
Ma'am, better you switch the video and you can proceed further without playing the same thing, because I think there is some technical glitch. So better you avoid the video and you can proceed further, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Okay. Anyway, that link is there. Just help me.
Ma'am, you can proceed further, ma'am.
I'm trying to get my PowerPoint. It's not seen here. Resume share.
I think you can just...
Yeah, I'm getting it. Yeah.
Up.
Fine. Now you're able to see that? Now you're able to see my presentation?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
I think your message has gone deeper. No problem, ma'am. You can just wind up. You can just sum up your presentation. You just say verbally a few words. And
then
get to the last speaker, please.
Yeah, sure. I will do that. So I am many real case studies. This is my last slide, actually. It is supposed to be the last slide. Real case studies of SBABA in diabetes. I was supposed to share some patient experiences slides, but no problem. It is available in SBABA Wisdom series. If you go to Facebook, if you visit FB group of SBEBA Wisdom Series, you can see that real case study. So this patient was also having so many drugs, like 20 medicines, total for three diseases, including three oral hypoglycemic agents. And he was taking 26 units of insulin. So that got reversed in 3 months. The diabetes got reversed. The last week, his HbA1c is 5.3. So before it was 10, about 10, when he was taking three drugs. So this is possible by science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda. You will see many real case studies in our group of SBEBA Wisdom Series. Okay. So to conclude, science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda has curative strategies for type 2 diabetes. SBEBA has highly specific and specialized techniques to detect the exact cause mechanism specific to each subject behind hyperglycemia and reverse the same. And hence, I repeat, SBEBA, science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda, is not cookbook medicine. It is not appropriate to take single herbs like turmeric, amlaki, guluchi, etc., without understanding the specific cause mechanisms responsible for initiation of diabetes in a patient. It is equivalent to tribal medicine, and Ayurveda is not a herbal tradition or tribal medicine. It is science-based, evidence-based medicine. There are specific and specialized guidelines which determines what condition it is, how to diagnose, how to reverse. There are treatment principles and diagnostic principles. It's not based on medicine-oriented. It is based on science-oriented approach. SBEBA is entirely different from conventional Ayurveda practices. It is high time to convert conventional Ayurveda practices in a scientific way to science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda. Tomorrow Ayurveda, I pray sincerely that tomorrow Ayurveda will be addressed as science-based, evidence-based Ayurveda only, with a fully equipped Ayurveda community. And SBEBA is that only. And SBEBA services are able to be rendered only by completely professionally trained SBEBA practitioners. We are providing training to Ayurveda doctors in SBEBA Wisdom Series, seminars and webinars. So for more details, you can contact my mail ID, drramyaraj@gmail.com. This is actually an awareness created for the purpose of, not for any other personal benefits or advantages. It is solely for the purpose of upliftment of our science of Ayurveda to its intended status. Once again, I thank sir and all the organizers and of course the audience who are patient to listen to me. Thank you very much. Namaste.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ramya. And Dr. Rao, you will get the Nobel Prize for the patience which you got, because quarter to 10, you are getting your chance.
Yeah.
Because it has never happened in the history.
Sir, it is. Sir, thank you.
The program has gone up to quarter to 10, but in a very lighter way, because I always remain happy, and that is the secret. At the age of 70, I believe like a 20-year-old boy, because I'm a very happy person. Because there are certain things beyond your control and there are certain things within your control. So when they are beyond your control, just laugh on them. So, Dr. Rao, I recommend to the Guinness Book of Records for you getting a Patience Award of the Year 2020. So
thank you, sir.
Yeah, let's get across and let's listen to your views, what you have got to share, and where are you? I'm trying to locate you. Where are you? Yes, there you are. Please go ahead.
Good evening, one and all. First of all, I want to say thank you to our young boy, Gulshan sir. Yeah, because from the starting onwards, I was observing, sir is so young and so active. Even though from 9:30 onwards, sir is there in the online.
Dr. Raf, I want to tell you the secret. I'm 70 years old. I think like a 20-year-old boy. And today is an exceptional evening. I sleep at 9 and I get up at 3:30 in the morning. I'm a pure vegetarian. I'm a teetotaler, non-smoker, and I grow my own vegetables, which I eat. So let's go ahead.
Oh, very nice.
Ayurveda, we will practice. Okay, let's go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. And once of all, once again, I will thank to all other panelists and Anshul, sir, and other Chitra and all. First, my topic is diabetic retinopathy and its management. what is diabetic retinopathy? There is a damage to the retinal vessel tissue, which is there in the diabetes for more than 5 or 10 years. So if the in the type 1 diabetes after 5 years, in the type 2 diabetes after 10 years, the retinal damage will start. So main culprit or main important key point in the diabetic retinopathy is the lack of oxygen supply to the retina. Retina is a one layer which is present inside the eyeball. Okay, so if there is a lack of oxygen supply, hypoxia is the main thing to develop the retinal changes. So this can lead to the producing the VEGF. VEGF means vascular endothelial growth factor. So after that, so once the retina is not getting the oxygen, it is trying to get the oxygen from the blood vessels. What is the blood circulation is coming to the retina. So first it is trying to get naturally, but it is not sufficient. It is not getting the oxygen because of the all the risk factors. Then blood vessels starting dilating and pooling the blood into the retina. Then also that we call that mechanism we call microaneurysm. There is a dilatation of the blood vessels and pooling of the blood into the retina directly. Then also our retina is not satisfied. After that it's breaking and blood is leaking inside the retina. After that some exudates also coming and it's depositing the different areas of the retina. Then after that there is a macular edema also happen because of the, all the pooling on all things. Finally, the patient is getting the vision loss. This is the total mechanism happening in the diabetic retinopathy. I'm not taking much time. I'm not able to eat to your brain because since long you are waiting. So I am sharing my slides. Yeah, can you able to see my slides?
Yeah, it has come. It has come.
Yeah.
Please go ahead.
Yes, thank you, sir. So this diabetic retinopathy is one of the complication of the diabetes if it is more than 5 years. And in the one study in the 2015, around 145 million people are suffering with diabetic retinopathy. It will reach to 224 million people in 2040. And according to WHO, around who all are getting the blind, 4.8% people are becoming blind because of the diabetic retinopathy. And it is around 25 to 70 years of the age people are getting the diabetic retinopathy frequently than other age group. So these all are the risk factors who all are already uncontrolled diabetes is there, or even though it is a control, the history is more than 5 years, the glucose levels are increased and person is obese and pregnant ladies, hypertensive people, smoking, alcohol, and the aged people. These all are people are getting diabetic retinopathy. Yeah, in this pictures, you can see first picture, left upper picture is the obesity and the down picture is the pregnancy. Don't get confused. Then the clinical features are, the first persons are asymptomatic. In the starting stage, patient is not feeling any complaints. Gradually, the person getting something is floating in front of the vision. Floaters means something is moving in front of the eyes, which is not present also. Then gradually, there is some dark empty areas are observed in the vision. And poor night vision is present, and along with there is colors are not perceived by the patient, and gradually vision is fluctuating, and he becoming the blur. The vision is blurring, and after that vision loss is progress. Gradually it will take more than some people. It is the patient is following all the healthy diet and all. It will take time, or else gradually after 5 years these changes will start. But starting stage patient is not having any symptom. Okay, after 5 or 10 years, it will start. On the examination, we find some changes in the retina. Even though patient is not telling, if the patient is coming to the ophthalmologist, we will check the retina, how it is. First starting microaneurysm will start, and all things depend upon the clinical features. Diabetic retinopathy is divided into two types. One is the non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, another one the proliferative diabetic retinopathy. And again, it having the subtypes, mild, moderate, and severe, and depend upon the all other clinical features. First starting clinical feature is the microaneurysm, means there is a dilatation of the blood vessels and there is a small, small dot-like bleeding spots present in the city. After that, the blood vessels are broken, and two type of hemorrhage we can observe. Along with the hemorrhage, we observe the some deposits that we call as exudates. The exudates also two types. One is the soft exudates, another one is the hard exudates. Soft exudates we call as a cotton wool spots. Another one is the hard exudates. The second picture shows the soft exudates. In the third picture, we are observing some yellow spots that we call as a hard exudates. Along with that, there is a hemorrhage. Okay, there is a bleeding spots we can observe. Okay, the bleeding, if it is present in the superficial layer of the retina, is looks like a flame shaped hemorrhage, and the deep tissues of the retina is having the dot blood sign. Okay, dot blood like a small dots like bleeding spots can be observed. After that, macula also getting edematous, and all the fourth picture shows the all clinical features. Okay, hard exudates are there, soft exudates also there. There is a hemorrhage, two type of hemorrhage also can observe in this. So that is the non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. If we are not taking any changes or any medication and all, then gradually it is changing into the proliferative diabetic retinopathy that we call as a PDR. In the PDR, we observe there is a new vessel formation because of the VEGF, what I already told, vascular endothelial growth factor, which is secreted from the retina and hypoxic retina, that can leads there is a proliferation of the means there is a new capillaries are developing in the retinal tissue. Why this new tissue, new vessels are developing? Because of retina is need oxygen. So usually retina is getting oxygen from the blood only. So there is a breaking of the blood vessels happening, bleeding is occurred, some amount of the oxygen is getting. Even though retina is not satisfying with that, gradually after some days, new capillaries is developing and new circulation is coming to the retina. That is happening in the two forms. One is the neovascularization of the disc, which is happen around the optic disc. Another one is the NVE, neovascularism elsewhere, means peripheral retina also getting new vessels and circulation. After that, the pooling of the all the things are happening and macula is getting edematous. That is one of the complications of the diabetic retinopathy. After that, all the hemorrhage is accumulating in the vitreous humor and vitreous hemorrhage. The fourth picture shows the vitreous hemorrhage. Third picture shows the macular edema. Usually in the ophthalmologist, they are giving the anti-VEGF medicines they are giving. Beta blockers they are giving, and they are giving all the other medications. There is a cortisone injection they are giving. Even though there is a bleeding is not stopped, then they go for the laser surgery and they'll pass the laser beam and they will start burning where the blood is bleeding is occurred. So that areas you can the picture, this last picture you can observe there is a white to the dots. That is the laser burns. So they will burn that area. Because of that, the bleeding is stopped. Bleeding is stopped, but vision is not improved. Totally loss is happening. So in this stage, if the patient is coming to us, we are in the Ayurveda also, we are unable to do anything. But before that, if the bleeding is there also, we can manage with Ayurvedic medication. Usually, Madhumeha Upadrava it is taking as a diabetic retinopathy, and Pooja Pada Muni, he told in the Netra Prakasha, if the diminished vision happened in the Madhumeha also. Here, depend upon the clinical features, microaneurysm, hemorrhage, this all are the happening because of Pitta Rakta Dosha, and exudates occur because of the Pitta Dosha and Kapha Dosha, and proliferation is happening because of the Kapha and Rakta. Okay, in this, there is a Sapta Mardaloha, like that medicines we are using internally, and Trifla taking is very effective. And some, these all are the drugs is, which is working on the diabetes and along with the IDCS also, and having the rasayana property, is giving the nourishment to the all the body tissues. So Amlaki, Haritaki, Vipitaki, these all are the drugs is very effective in this. I will show only few important, very important drugs in the which is useful in the diabetic retinopathy. One is the Vasa. So this Vasa is the Malmar nut. It is very important drug to stop the bleeding, and which even though it is the bleeding is there, it will be reduced with this taking the medicine. Okay, in the different forms we can give, there is a Vasa Valahia, Vasa Rishta form, and different in the Kashaya taking in, Mr. preparing Potapaka Swarasa taking, and they're giving internally, and all the things for Talpana purpose, Potapaka purpose we are using. So it's a very wonderful drug, can use in the diabetic retinopathy. And Amlaki, okay, this can everybody can take. okay, amla ki churna or amla ki juice taking, but I prefer fresh amla ki juice taking is very effective than what is a ready-made available. Okay, I not prefer any ready-made amla ki juice advising. Amla ki juice mixing with haridra, is haridra also rasayana property is there and it having the chakshusha property, it is very effective. And yashadabhasma and amla ki churna we will advise, but with the doctor prescription also should be followed. And decoction taking of the triphala decoction taking at night time is very effective. So amla ki is an antioxidant, this is one of the rasayana property having the drug, it's very effective. And next one is the punarnava. Punarnava is that the name itself indicates that punarnava. Okay, it is new tissues are developed with this. What is the damaged tissue are there, and this is the rasayana drug, and where is the damage is there, the damage is reduced and new tissue will develop with the punarnava. So this is a wonderful drug. It is having the multi-system action. It is also Sweta Punarnava is indicated in eye diseases. There's a Ashwatthana purpose and Anjana formation, and internally also they're given. It's also one of the important drugs. And different special procedures, Akshitarpana, Jalukavacharna, Nasya, these all of the procedures are very effective. The Jalukavacharna is having the stopping the bleeding and it stop the further new bleeding. And what is the bleeding already is there, it is reabsorbed. So we are following the Jalukavacharna, that is nothing but leech therapy. Okay, and that the doctor supervision should be followed. And the first picture shows the Ashwatthana and second one shows the Akshitarpanam. It gives direct nourishment. If there is a damage is there, that tissues will be regenerate with that. And Sekam and Pindi and Kavalika, this all of the procedures are very effective. And in the Panchakarma, Nasyakarma and Virechana is very effective. First we follow the Virechana, then only we'll follow the all other treatments. And along with all other diabetic precautions, the daily stress management is very, very important. There is a physical stress and mental stress both should be. And finally, I'll advise pranayama is very important. With the pranayama, it usually give oxygen supply to each and every tissue of the body. So pranayama is working. So there is already starting, I given one important clue, as hypoxia is the main cause for the diabetic retinopathy. If you are doing pranayama and along with all other medications, oxygen is supplied to the retina and retina further damage will not be happening. Thank you so much. We are having the Netra Special Clinic in the Coimbatore under the AVP Research Foundation. If you any patients, you can refer to us and we are following all the treatment protocols and all. Thank you so much. I am not eating all your brain. Thank you one and all.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rao. It was wonderful, wonderful climax. You put it so lightly and in such a humorous way. I'm so grateful to you.
And yeah, because I want to follow that time, what given the time, I want to follow that.
God bless you.
That I completed very fastly.
We will certainly visit sometime Coimbatore. And you are...
Yes.
I wish to see Sadhguru's place over there. That is
yes.
Great attraction for all of us. And thank
you. Yeah, thank you, sir. We will meet once.
Yes, thank you very much for the patience of the first speaker and the last speaker, I think. Because Dr. Srivastava, having done his initial dose and thereafter the entire journey. And I think the national award will go to Anshul Agrawal for being a part of this program till this time, because he's so patiently, you know. So thank you very much, because subject was actually such, I didn't want to interrupt anybody. A lot of requests had come from world over. People wrote to us from the different countries. That's why I wanted that all of you should have your own say. All of you should give the best possible. And I think, Anshulji, now we are following the correct pathy, that instead of bringing different speakers to talk on different things, let's take one subject of Ayurveda and every week let's do justice with one part. I think that is something. Now,
definitely, Gulshanji will follow the same pattern in the coming weeks as well.
Yes, it was wonderful this evening, if you ask my heart, because people got the complete package. And what I would request you is, now you got to give one package for eyes, because we are watching too much of monitors the whole day. And the second one you have to give for the avoiding spondylitis and all those kind of things and everything. And what Dr. Rao mentioned, very politely, I will say, 2 hours I do pranayam early in the morning, and that is the secret of my energy. And
yeah, very know, nice, sir.
Very nice.
Keeps me so agile, so beautiful, so wonderful. I'm the most happy person on this planet. And I personally feel that everything is within the body. You can recover in a natural way. It's all your thought process, and it's all how you want to look after yourself. So my great regards and deep regards and gratitude to all the speakers today. You all have done wonderful. My thanks to you. And Anshul, it was a wonderful experiment after 13 Saturdays. Today, what we have done, it's a wonderful journey. And we are going to follow this. You got to be taking one session separately on eyes. One has yes, to be yes. taken on spondylitis. And thereafter, I will keep, I have told you, a lot of people have already requested me. They are having a problem of the joints. When they go to temples, they go to gurdwaras. When they sit down, they can't get up. When they get up, they find it very difficult to sit down on the floor. So a lot to be done. So with a smile from Anshul Agrawal, all of us, we should be winding up this evening. My deep gratitudes and thanks to all of you. Dr. Abhishek ji, where are you based?
Sir, I'm based in Lucknow. I have started Sri Sri Tattva Panchakarma Center in Lucknow.
Okay, you are so,
Yeah.
Abhay ji, you are in Pune. You're mute.
I'm in Nasik. Near Pune. It is a triangle between Pune and Bombay.
I've gone there after notes.
Sir, rakhe hai aapke liye. Please come and collect your notes.
Where are you based, ma'am? At present, where are you based? Mute hai aapka mic, mute hai. Your mic is mute.
Madam from Pondicherry.
Now is it audible, sir?
Yes, you are in Pondicherry.
I am not, sir. Exactly, I am working in Government of Pondicherry Institution, but I am staying closer to Mahi, Talasheri in Kannur district, Kerala. Okay.
Understood. So, yes. Rao Saab, you are in Coimbatore. And yes, yes. Anshul ji is the one who is creating pollution in Delhi. All the problem which is coming, more cases over there. Okay, and Gagandeep ji is also in Delhi. Okay, he's also in Delhi. So, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, ladies and gentlemen, world over, all my brothers and sisters who joined this particular program, you requested, we packed it for you. And I hope each one of you, whatever queries you have got, all the panelists must have put their details into the chat box, because then you can reach out to the people. You can talk to them. You can deal with them. You can share with them. The universe belongs to you, and all these Ayurvedists, they belong to universe. So with these words, great evening and great morning and great afternoon. And people, those are in Canada, Latin America and US, take care. You've got a long day and long, long work to do. And those are in UK, please go for your late evening tea and coffee now. And people in India, Shubh Ratri, good night to everybody. And see you next Saturday, that is for next Ayurveda program. And Anshul ji, God bless you. Thanks. Thank you. Namaskar. So